All right, welcome to another episode of Tabletop Throwdown.
Tabletop Throw Whip 12 Loss of Lieutenant Throwdown!
And Lobo's right out the gate looking for Uberfall on Uberfall action. We have Bakunin playing Forco, Whip 12's, I'm going to get their names mixed up, Kyle is playing Forco.
It's just like say the faction. Hope it goes well.
Yeah. And Lost of Lieutenants, Jacob, also known as Fumbly Manhands.
Fumbly Manhands.
Is rocking Bakunin. And they are playing B Pong.
Did you say they're rocking it?
I will now.
That's a good line, I think, actually. I'm quite pleased with it. Oh, I'm so excited to see this mission. It looks kind of chaotic.
It's basically soccer. You get the ball to the other side.
It's the most popular sport in the world, right? Easy peasy.
It's a little less like soccer now that I'm thinking about it. But let's get into it. Let's talk about the mission real quick, since it is brand new and shiny. Which means I have to push the button that says look at the thing. Let's run on down to the map real quick. So there's two buttons. There's an exclusion zone. There's a button on each side of the field, and dead center there's a tracking beacon is what it's called. I'll forget what it's called almost immediately. But if we jump back up to the scoring, at the end of each game round, if the tracking beacon's in the enemy half, you get a point. At the end of each game round, if you're controlling the tracking beacon, pretty standard control, you know, touch it with, and be the only one touching it, you get a point. And then at the end of each game round, control at least one console. So both people can score that point. So that's 3 points around, and then the last point is the classified. Now you're wondering how to move the tracking beacon. You can either
indeed I am.
You could punt it with this relocate the tracking beacon. You have a you have a specialist touching it, and you do a whip, a normal whip roll, and you can move it 4 inches. Okay. That specialist can only do that once per game round.
So you have to... okay. We are playing soccer. So you have to punt it to another specialist if you want to, like, move it further.
Right. The other way to move it is at the consoles. Wait, was that a whip roll? Sorry, no. Relocating the tracking beacon is an entire order, but there is no roll required.
Oh, good. I feel like we should see more objectives with that.
I like that structure.
Like, I don't want all of them to be that way, but I'd like to see more of them.
Sure. The other way you can move it is by activating a console. This is where you do the normal whip roll with a specialist touching the console. If it's failed, whatever. If you've successfully activated, you must perform one of the following. Nudge the tracking beacon, where you move it 2 inches, however you want. Or magnetize the tracking beacon, where it moves 6 inches towards the center of the game table.
I can't.
So it's got a bit of a Mario Kart. If you're ahead, it's harder to move the thing. Or if you're behind, it's easier to move the thing.
I think that's smart.
Sure.
Like, especially if it's like in a spot where it's like, oh man, he planted 30 mines around that. I would like to just not interact with that. That'd be great.
So an activated console cannot be activated again by the same player until the opponent has activated it. So this is once a turn. You can move it 2 inches with each console.
Well, what's interesting too is that, like, if your opponent activates it and it's your turn to activate the console, does that mean that if you then get ahead, they can't even use the consoles to get it back?
Say that again?
Like, that last bullet point, imagine a world where, say, we're playing, and you activated a console.
Uh-huh.
And then I got the beacon far into my zone, into that, like, 30-mine situation.
Sure.
Well, now you don't even have that option to push the button.
Right.
No, I had no, I...
Like, you,
but
you
I always,
have...
yeah. There's the other button. There is, you know, yeah, drilling or dribbling it, drilling it. I think that's basically it.
So how far does relocate move it?
4 inches.
It's always 4 inches?
Yep.
Oh, I see it now. Well, it's interesting. And so you get to move it, but you can't, like, go around corners. Because it's got to be line of fire between the start and end location.
Does it say that somewhere? Did I miss that?
Yeah, it's one of the rules. You must be able to draw a path between the tracking beacon starting and final positions.
Paths do not have to be straight.
Okay.
This is just to prevent it from going, like, into a wall.
Yeah.
So the other guy can't kick it, is what I'm getting. I mean, you probably, like, if you have a corridor table and sometimes there are those dead zones that you can't get to legally. I think
but
that's
this also means that you could, like, eat it up, yeah?
Yep, I don't see any reason it couldn't go up. Must be fully supported. Cannot be placed on a vertical surface.
I was watching one game.
I cannot wait to have somebody form what I will call the soccer team, which is a link of five specialists who take turns just going. That's really funny.
It's like children's soccer where they're all following the ball.
It's like a little crowd.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, that's funny.
Oh, that's great. I love this mission for that reason and that reason alone. And that's all I needed. OBS Kiss, it's nice. It's nice seeing you. We'll catch you when you watch the VOD later. Go.
Look forward to hearing it about it.
Yeah.
Your thoughts.
All right,
like,
we should.
Who does that best, do you think? Like, what faction is most excited to run a bunch of specialists?
I feel like...
I was at an event today and I brought Stormata and I felt like I had infinite specialists. So
sure.
I think they'd actually be really good at it. Like, the Capacore kind of thing.
Sure.
Like,
and I don't want to get too bogged down.
Sure.
I don't know if they're deploying it. Does not look like they're deploying it. So
yeah, Lobo agrees with me. Stormata, yep, that's the play. Turns out Stormata has a soccer team.
I was thinking, like, an Evader Corps could probably be pretty annoying about it.
Be fun. That's fantastic.
Robots love to play soccer. Yeah. But the interesting thing is, the more you put into it, the more it's going into their zone. So the harder it is, again, with that, like, self-balancing
keep
aspect.
Kicking it, right?
Yeah.
Oh, this is fun.
Yeah.
So we're looking at the Bakunin list real quick right here. Looks like we got a 5-man of a Custodier, Hacking Device Plus, Boarding Shotgun.
Is that not normal?
A pitcher for days. I always want the pitcher.
Oh, you give it the pitcher for that? That seems wrong. Like, I feel like that's not the model that you want to be trading templates with. Right?
Yeah, I go combi rifle pitcher every time, but it is another point, it looks like. He might not have had the points. So, yeah, he's right at 300. So,
for those of you just joining us, we were asked to watch a match between two different podcast hosts. And this is the time that lined up for them, because I believe one of them is in England. Yeah.
Australia.
So, yeah. All right. Yes. The place that that they came from or went to. The point is that this is the time slot that kind of works for everyone, where it's not egregious for anybody.
Yeah, I think we're representing.
That's one thing I actually kind of.
You're like one time zone off from me, and I think Kyle's also on this side. But
we're sometimes one zone off of you, like,
huh?
Because we don't do daylight savings,
mm-hmm.
So it rotates throughout the year. Actually,
yeah,
it's really annoying.
All right, so Custodier boarding shotgun couldn't fit that extra point in. We have two Moiras, one with a HMG and one with a sniper rifle.
Sure.
We were going to Mother Agatha, don't leave home without her. If you're rocking Reverends of some kind, I don't think I would ever.
Is she just leave the best one? Like before Kusanagi, she's the one.
I would take her before Kusanagi. I mean, Kusanagi's just kind of expensive.
I was curious where that fell on the characters.
Yeah.
Better.
Yeah. And then
because they're very different, right? Like Kusanagi is all fight.
Kusanagi is a specialist.
That's fair.
Whip 14 specialist. But
less adaptable. Like she does BS all right, but like Agatha has templates, can do close combat, has a specialist role beyond just being one.
Mm-hmm.
I think she's a more well-rounded trooper. Kusanagi's like, I bring the gun, die.
Yeah, I do like the multi-rifle profile. You get the multi-rifle, which of course has the different ammo types. EM grenade launcher and a zapper.
Yeah, the EM grenade launcher is a fun inclusion, now that she gets that on top of everything.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But not in this list. We got Agatha and a Cenobite rounding out the five-man. Cenobites are stupid cheap for her to throw in the core.
I mean, God, those prices are pretty good. How do you feel about the rocket versus this chain rifle profile?
He's probably out of... Oh, he's not out of Swick.
He could have. I mean, it's just points at this point. Right?
So his two real guns, big guns, are the HMG and the multi-rifle.
Okay, so it sounds like we want to get 7 points into this list from somewhere. Where would we cut to get 7 points?
Probably the Prowler. I always have a hard time.
That's a shame, because I really like the Prowler. And that's not the one I'd even choose, I don't think. Right? Like... That's a weird kit to want. You don't have like a handgun. Killer hackering device and boarding shotgun? Like, I feel like you want a hidden deployment guy to occasionally have value on a surprise ARO, but most of the time show up and do something really impactful. But like, all the Prowlers are specialists. They have specialist operative.
Mm-hmm.
You can just take like the Spitfire or even take the adhesive launcher so you can catch people off guard and like turn off a unit.
As far as like,
I don't know.
Sure.
I don't have an.
But I think you could cut points from the Prowler to both give the Cenobite a rocket launcher and give the pitcher to the Custodier and still have 30 points for a lot of options. So yeah.
If you're playing with the ITS 15 rules, and we are, because this is B-Pong.
Yeah, this is B-Pong. It has to be.
Drop the Stempler to a Flash Pulse spot. That's valid.
That would do it.
That's
super straightforward, and then you don't have to give up anything, because clearly he wants the killer hacker, right? He likes that idea.
Sure.
It's just fine. It's fine. But yeah, if you cut that and then swap the Cenobite to the rocket and the Custodier to the pitcher, I think this list is great.
Alas.
All right, let's get through everything else. So there's the five-man, and then there's Brand DeCastro.
Congratulations to Carlos Bostria for his new son named Bran. That literally happened this weekend, I think.
Okay. I thought there was a joke there I was not getting.
No. Straight up, I believe I saw a news update that his kid was named Bran, and I was like, that's great. I like that.
That's awesome.
Because Bran DeCastro was his character in the RPG that they played many, many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's very fun.
And then we got a couple moderators. He's got four different moderator lieutenant options.
Truly playing the guessing game. I mean, you can't really ask for better cheap orders, yeah. Unless you're one.
I mean, yeah. Unless you're in Cha, 9 points for a regular order is pretty solid. But he doesn't have flashbulb spots, right? You could sneak more Morlocks in there.
Mm-hmm. Regardless, seems like solid list. I think that group two is a little confused in terms of like.
All right, let's finish group one real quick.
Yeah, all right, fine.
Okay, so the two moderators, Brand DeCastro, Prowler with the boarding shotgun and killer hacking device. This guy is in deployment. We'll see what he does with them, because late game this can do some work. Mimetism -3, just popping out of nowhere. And then he's got the Chimera that Lobo was looking for. And that
I hope we get one on both sides. That'd be funny.
Spoiler alert, we might.
Spoilers.
So group one is those 9 regular orders and 1 irregular order on the Chimera. Oh. Group two is just like leftover stuff. We got 2 more locks. Which ones did he take? The DA CCWs. Over EM.
Was there any possibility? What was the other mission?
Huh?
What was the other mission that we were offering them?
Oh, mind wipe. Makes sense.
There we go. That's why.
Makes sense. Cool. I was confused. So 2 more locks, great smoke throwers. Semplers on as your ex Takimoto bot. Now it's just back down to being a sensor bot.
Just a moto bot now, no tacky.
And then, yeah, the other 2 moderators. Whoops. And?
Yeah, I feel like that second group is confused.
What are you... It needs something to do, right? Like,
yeah, just put Brand down there. Easy. First turn, that's where the orders go, and then maybe position the Stempler and position the Warlocks. So you just jump Brand in somewhere. That's totally fine. And then later you can move stuff to the other group.
Can we ban whoever that was? Yeah. So yeah, I'd actually throw the Chimera into group 2 and maybe a Morlock into group 1. But that is me. Let's take a look at the foreign company list. I'm just gonna look for it. There it is. Chimera with 3 pup necks.
Okay.
Now Keith.
Yeah.
So right off the top, we got 5 Securitates.
Securitate.
We've got a Fuhrbach, an HMG, a hacker, a lieutenant, and a lieutenant alternate. And these guys are BS-12, so the HMG and Fuhrbach are actually scary.
They're a real quality core link for their price. Like, in terms of how effective they can be, since they can very easily be pure with good utility and good guns. Like, I remember at Krug, I fought just a core link of these guys, and it's just like, it was hard to beat BS-15, man. It's just, like, annoying.
It's pretty solid. CSU also counts as a Securitate, so he's got... Uh-huh. He's got a spare tire for the Fuhrbach, it looks like.
I enjoy calling it spare tire.
It's so accurate. Although it makes me try to think of a 5-wheeled vehicle, and it doesn't work.
You can right click.
Not a common configuration.
Then we've got the Chimera, who we kind of skipped over, but is a beast in CC with eclipse grenades.
Really beat her if you're punching.
One model,
right?
Nope. Natural born warrior, CC attack -3, and martial arts. Just like, all the things.
Is there anybody who has a real shot at it? There's not, right?
No.
Not a good one.
And especially because you also get the pupniks going. I mean, reactively, sure, right? There's plenty of like +2 burst people who could walk up to her and do some shit.
Yes.
But active turn, she's not scared of nothing.
My answer is apply your template and say goodbye.
And then I was just looking at their fire team list. It does look like this Bolt Avicenna Massacre is a pure... Nope, not a pure link. Not that that really matters. Because it's 3 man.
Yeah. But that's a hot link. I like that. You get a lot of... flexibility in those 3 models.
You've got pretty solid gunfighter with BS-13 marksmanship with a hyperst gun in the bolt. You've got Avicenna as a doctor extraordinaire with effectively 2 wounds.
Incredible doctor.
Not shock immune. No, she's combi and flash pulse. Flash pulse with whip 15 though is pretty solid.
I see what happened. He's using a 3D model, and he like changed the name of it to Avicenna, but it's It's clearly a Gulon. Like, he adjusted a few stats, but the weapon still says rifle like shotgun. I was like, gotcha. What? Really? Wow.
And then Senior Massacre is another CC monster.
And, like, monster in the same way that the Pupnik is.
Very similar. Like, yeah, martial arts and natural-born warrior.
Terrifying.
And an honestly, EMCCW.
Yeah, with a better weapon. There are very few things I'd say that are better than Viral, but EMCC is certainly the one, right?
Yep.
Unless you're fighting bears.
Unless you're fighting bears.
Specifically that. But, like, oh, and he also has Eclipse, so, like, having two sources of Eclipse is pretty great, actually.
Yeah, that's really good. That's an EM grenade zone.
Say again, bud?
Just a heads up, there were a couple models that did not exist, so I sort of modified the profiles a little bit. But
I was just laughing that this is clearly a Gulam. Like,
right.
Cool, because it says rifle like shotgun. I was like, she has a shotgun? Really? Yeah.
So when I go to edit it, it doesn't...
it doesn't show you those lower lines. I know you're talking about.
Yeah. So I figured...
We'll keep us on our toes.
Right. I think it's her...
All right, so that's group one, and then group two is Beast Hunter, Clockmaker, Zero Killer Hacker.
In mind.
He brought a Pathfinder, so he's got a, that's their drum bot, yeah? Or their sensor bot. Yep. And a Croc Man. So they got Hidden Deployment on both sides. They've got a Chimera on both sides.
But also I've seen a Croc Man. How long were they called Paradiso Croc Man? Is that a title change?
You're asking the wrong guy, man.
If I'm being honest, I'm asking the chat.
That is a good point, Lobo, that the Chimera and Senior Massacre basically... Well, a coin flip if it's just the two of them, right? But the Chimera... Chimera is going to get a Pupnik involved.
Massacre is just going to shoot her with Breaker. I guess either way, that is what would happen. But there is the upside that Massacre is actually a fair bit tougher in terms of just, like, defensive stats. Like, having access to Regeneration and Armor 2 and BTS 3.
Okay.
Like, he gets up pretty common. Oh, he also has EM grenades. That's pretty rad. Very useful.
So the second group here has a bunch of random stuff in it. Beast Hunter is the cheap guy you could throw orders at to try and take stuff out. Clockmaker, can the Clockmaker work on anything? The Pathfinder and the Chimera. That is it.
Does he have a... Did I miss that he has a zero?
Zero Killer Hacker?
Yeah.
Oh, I see it now. Sorry, I'm just blind. Don't listen to me.
I try not to. Just kidding.
I.
What they had done with the.
Who's the Foco player?
The Foco player is definitely somebody. It's not the last. It's Kyle.
Kyle. Alright. I just noticed that he has, if you look at the orange camo marker, and that's a Beast Hunter, and it is definitely the FTO one, which is not in camo state.
Okay, so let's look at...
I'll reach out.
Reach out and turn... I think...
Hey, Kyle, you're a Foco, right?
First.
Yeah.
Okay. Please look at your messages.
Okay.
And which of you is going first?
Tyler.
Okay, thanks. So, Foreign Company is going first also. Going from left to right, behind a car about a foot from the left and towards the back of his deployment zone is his Pathfinder. He's got a Clockmaker right in front of it, so looks like his job is clear. And then kind of spread throughout the middle back of his deployment is his Securitate CSU link with the Fearbach.
And Mind Layer.
Hmm?
Yeah, they have Mind Layer, but they don't have camo and forward deployment. So.
Yeah. Sorry, he's just realizing that. So he had deployed his Beast Hunter up here in camo. I was like, I don't think he has the camo one.
Mm.
So he's figuring that out now. He's like, ah, yes.
Gotcha. He's going first, so he has nothing standing up for ARO from his five man. He has a zero hacker. Oh, of note, there is an exclusion zone in this mission.
Yep. Which they've been good about. Each of our only four squares in, so
six is fine. Looks like he's moving his Beast Hunter somewhere. And his three man's on the right with Avicenna, Massacre, and a Bolt.
Which I feel like he's deployed like he's going first. Like, those three wouldn't be just there. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like they'd be more
close.
Right. What I mean is, like, when you see the models lined up like that, you're like, all right, well, clearly that's not.
Sure.
If he was going
sure.
second, you wouldn't put him there. Or you'd die.
Sure. And then on the other side, Bakunin side, we have.
The other side, yeah.
Far left is a Morlock. We got two moderators kind of tucked in the back. We've got his HVT. Where is the Forco HVT?
It's right in the middle.
I see it. There it is. Okay.
Seems like a pretty fine spot. Although some people will be able to like easily get it over the wall. Depends on what objective people get.
Yeah, any zone of control stuff is like, thank you.
Yeah.
Which securing is, right? Like,
yeah.
I normally don't do this kind of thing anymore because of that. I'd rather have it standing out in the open than
especially
that's
on like one of the sides where you have some control over it.
Mm-hmm. And also when you're going first, like he is.
So we're looking at the Bakunin deployment or no?
He's still deploying, so not yet, but if you wanted to say something, you can.
But see, assuming this is where the nuns end up, I'm not a particular fan of the sniper location. Like, if you're going to try to take advantage of the ODD and really punish things, this is a really limited vision. Like, I would have liked to see her, like, all the way to the left of that building, just like, still same level, just literally slide her left an inch. And she sees so much more.
You mean that alley on the right that he's got no units in?
Right, it's just like, but why not have more control using your model?
I mean, he can see this way, right?
All right, that is true. I did not see the left angle, but it's super tight. I guess I'm uncertain whether I would have put my nuns there or on like the left building where I feel like you have better access to fire lanes. Like the spot right here is really good in terms of like it sees the opposing high end, it sees the whole alleyway, it also sees across through the same spot he's looking at right now, as well as most of the map. I just think that there's better lines of fire for what is arguably the most powerful ARO piece on the map.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I mean, just the way he's deployed, you know, there's going to be, he hasn't deployed his Chimera yet, has he?
Yeah, he has not. And you can kind of counter deploy your Chimeras, but I guess that would still get you kind of killed sometimes.
Mm-hmm. They just run at each other and 1v1 each other.
I mean, I'm not going to lie. I've had local tournaments where people have challenged my honor, and I have just made terrible decisions because I am susceptible to being intimidated into bad choices. I understand. Case in point, I just agreed not to shoot at his Oyoroi, who was at one health, so that I could close in with my Guija and melee him, and then I got crit and died. I was like, no!
That's just called having fun, Tim.
I hope that this whole group of nuns doesn't get eaten by some Morlock. Or not more Uberfall.
Just real quick, you guys, I wanted to just point out that this is ITS 15, so no Takimoto Combat jump into exclusion zones a thing. The command token to add an order to your pool is a thing.
Oh, yeah. Who does that? Me or him or both of us?
Both of us.
Everyone can.
It's literally like...
Once per turn.
Instead of converting in a regular order, you can just convert a command token.
It's really strong.
Yeah, it's got to be at the very beginning. It's a tactical phase thing, but yeah.
Oh, is it? Oh, okay. Isn't
tactical phase is the command tokens.
Right, strategic phase.
Strategic phase is at the beginning of the game. Tactical phase is at the beginning of every turn.
Yeah.
Tactical phase is like when you move groups and stuff. Which, let me bring that up since I have the PDF right here.
Which is, all right, without talking about it, which is your favorite new rule? Just name it.
Yeah.
I don't really like them.
Oh, all right, none of them. All right, fuck them all. It's still a 6-4 special. Well, let's talk about it.
Yeah, let me pull it up so people can look at what we're talking about.
Anyone tell you that they're not?
That was the wrong button. Yeah. Okay, there we go. So, whoops.
Pathfinders and Fugazi and
so every one of my list. Bunch of the rules that were there are gone. I feel like there were 5 before. I don't remember. But long service is the one that makes characters veterans. Which is fine. O12's Prestige is a terrible name for a thing that tells me nothing about what it does.
It's not great. I'm not proud of that one. It's not good.
Okay, once per game round, expending a command token during your tactical phase adds one regular order to one of your combat groups.
Okay.
This directly goes against the beginning of game thing where you take away 2. Now they could spend 1 to bring it up to 1, and if they have counterintelligence, it's just like you don't even care anymore. Which I think is a weird choice.
Jim, help us out.
Ah.
Keep me honest, okay? Right. That's there.
Oh, I see it. I recognize and I see. You may continue.
Actually, you know what? I'm actually.
I recognize the cheating occurring, and I allow it.
There you go. Done.
I did not catch that for the viewers, but I will zoom into where is Croc.
And then that's it.
Was that the Croc Man?
That's my deployment.
Or was that the Prowler?
Wait,
which side were? It's the Prowler. Okay. Prowler's right there.
Yeah, because it was the it was on back on the inside. Yeah.
I went to see which side it was, and I went over a chimera. It was not helpful.
Okay, so starting from my left, right?
Oh, wild.
Oh, that's fantastic.
The
Prestige.
Prestige? Yeah.
Prestige.
You just get an extra order every round. It'll burn through command tokens.
I don't like it on the first turn. I don't know.
The very, very first turn of the game, I don't like it. Other than that, it's fine.
Yeah, I think it's fine elsewhere. I would be happy if you couldn't do it first turn.
Sure. And the name makes no sense at all.
It's
yeah.
not good. Yeah, it's not. It's like O12 Prestige combines slowly slides a command token across the board. Like, I would like my order, please. Like, sir, we don't serve your kind here. This is a Wendy's.
Oh, someone hasn't read the new book.
Oh, no. No. I do. I understand. But, like, are they officially part of O12?
They're not part of O12.
That's what I mean. It's weird.
But O12 kind of presents... Anyways, we don't need to get into fluff.
I'd love to get into some fluff later, though. Maybe later in the... I want to return to this topic later when we're not starting. All right.
And then border skirmishes is a weird one to me because it only applies to missions with exclusion zones.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, climbing.
But like, why not?
So it's weird to me that it's included in all missions, technically, right? It's right here. I don't know. Seems weird to me.
So my thought on that is that I feel like exclusion zones in their first incarnation were intended to prevent people from... Because at the time, during N3, when they showed up, they the game was really flooded with gamma markers. Just like in the... like, Foxtrot was one of the best units in the game. You would just get objectives done and just be in the middle of the zone and do all the missions and run away. And the game has changed a lot since then.
Cheating.
So, but I feel like people are not bringing drop troops as much. I really feel like it happens a lot less. But I would like to... And that's, a lot of that is because the value that they bring in a tournament setting is often less. You can't show up when you need to.
All right, someone's disagreeing with me about when the tactical use of command token is. I might be wrong. I've been wrong before.
At least twice.
Let me look that up.
But yeah, I think that that rule is going to... I like it because it keeps the powerful part of drop troops good. Or at least playable.
You guys, I was wrong. Tactical use is during your turn.
Wait, I wasn't ready. I need to say that again. I need to record it.
Oh, cool. We didn't cheat in my last practice game we had in it. Yeah, so it's just like if you get to the
end. I've been wrong before.
Yeah, but I want it as a soundbite.
No.
Well, I mean, it's being recorded, so
excellent.
You can put forth the effort.
Ask John to do it. Hey, John, can you give me a soundbite of Clint saying I'm wrong?
Timestamp is around 39 minutes and a half in. Sorry, 36 and a half.
Yeah. So,
you've missed nothing, Hyperion. They're still deploying as near as I can tell.
We shouted a bit about B-Pong, and then about... We're talking about the new rules. But I think that dropship should have that flexibility, but you don't want people to deploy infiltrating just next to objectives in a lot of missions. I think that's fine.
So I get it's an incentive to bring drop troopers in when there's an exclusion zone.
Seems like they should have done that during Thunderclap.
Sure.
Right? They did like no drop troop adjustments for something that was supposed to be themed after drop troops.
Sure. But it seems weird that they deploy better in exclusion zone missions. Like, they don't need to roll and they could just go there.
Don't they need to roll? Wait, what's the wording on it again?
The wording is they don't need to roll.
Okay.
That's what the wording is.
So what's the wording?
If the trooper is using combat jump, no PH rolls required, but they must deploy in silhouette contact with the edge of the exclusion zone.
Okay, that's weird that you can go to the middle of the map with that, I guess. Okay, that's strange. Because that just means that you could get to deploy on the 6-inch zone somewhere and you just show up, right?
Yep.
But I think I'm okay with it because it's predictable.
I don't hate it balance-wise.
Yeah.
This is more of a, there's an exclusion zone, so I show up better? What? I don't.
Yeah.
Like, if this was the same thing, but you didn't need the exclusion zone to do it, I'd be fine with it.
And is that the only way you can use this rule? Or was there a second way?
What?
Is it just just the one way you described? There's no other way to deploy?
Yeah, once per game, can deploy a trooper with airborne deployment label inside any exclusion zone. So it requires an exclusion zone to do it.
Okay.
But looks like we've got some Chimera going down.
Well, yeah.
And that counts at... So, last clarification, that still counts as combat jumping, right?
Oh, of course. They're just not rolling.
So Lu Zheng and Cascuda coming in? Huh?
Yeah.
This is pretty good. Yeah, it's got to be... It's for the Cascuda. Has anybody played a game with a Cascuda yet? I've not myself. But it's been around. It's long enough to actually get one. What's people's thoughts on it? Still seems real strong. Looks like they're still deploying Pupniks.
Yeah, the Pupniks on this side are deployed. Oh, we should talk about his deployment. We didn't really go over that. So yeah. I'll start on the right this time because that's where his Reverend Link is. His sniper did stay where... Oh, no, he's tucked in even further. He sees less now.
I hate it. I hate it so much. It's like the main reason to bring the multi-sniper, right? Because it's like a fucking brick to dislodge.
Well, I mean, active turn, if it's even pretty solid, too.
I don't know. Like, you're just going to let them get free. If you're playing as Foco, you want to not give them a free approach. And, like, unless that you saw them deploy, like, a Grenz or Marksmanship sniper. No, that's not even this faction. I'm thinking Tunguska. Who would you not want to put your sniper up against in Foco? I guess a Bolt Sniper.
Yeah.
So I think I'm good. All right.
That's
cool.
The one. Yeah, I don't know.
All right. Like so Reverend Link on the right with a Morlock right in front of him.
Sorry, the Cenobite's in a weird spot, too.
Dead center, we've got a couple moderators. Left of center, we have his Pupnik, his Uberfall Commando team. Far left, we have moderator Combi and another Morlock. Dead
show
center.
Them where the Prowler is.
I already did. It is between these two buildings, kind of up against this sign here.
Yeah. Which, per Killer Hackers, perfectly functions. It's there to do the objective, right?
Sure.
Model's not going to go in that corner. Yeah, cool.
He does not have a Harris, does he? No, he does not.
Yeah, he just forgot it. Did you catch where the croc man was? I did
not.
Okay. What? The Beast Hunter's in a funny spot. I think he just wants to put him back where he wanted him initially. Like, he's just going to hop up there. Are we off to the races?
Oh, I didn't put out a mine for my Beast Hunter.
Oh,
where did the Chimera end up? Oh, just in the... The Chimera is tucked in the bus. They put her in the bus.
Oh, in between these
vans. It's a little party in there.
Cute.
The Bakunin party. They're trying to lure all the Bakunin ladies in.
They're going to run straight at the reverends.
Yeah, because they're not watching them with a sniper rifle. It's just, I don't know why... You even have a doctor there to get her back up. I don't know. Like, I would love to see the setup in the current organization here. Sniper on the left side of the building. Mother Agatha on the upper level so that she can doctor it before the Link moves out. And the Cenobite in the ground level, kind of watching the corner with templates. That would be how I'd like lay that out.
With the amount of prone tokens he has right now, he is... That Cenobite is going to see down there anyways.
Right, but I would like to see have Mother of up there next to the sniper who might go down.
Sure.
But, yeah, if he could just run the Uberfall in, like, what would see him? Just the Morlocks on the way? Yeah, nothing is giving friction.
Sure. Whatever.
This Morlock.
Hey, they have a drop pod token. In that
one anyway. Yep.
Does it make a noise?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
That's a try.
Cool, I'm going to roll some superior infiltration.
Brando Castro.
There you get it.
Yeah. Oh, Brando Castro was his reserve, and that's what he was rolling. I was. Confused.
Oh my god, he's going to... Those do say no deployment on them. I don't know if you want to play with that.
Sorry. Oh, okay. Yeah, no, that's fine.
That's again, you guys don't have to follow that. Just wanted to point out that I saw that.
I don't care. You can be on if you want. Okay. Monkey Man can be there and he'll be fine.
I mean, I've got a super jumping template, so I think.
That's a weird spot to put Bran.
Well, I mean, if he's prone,
which he is,
what can see him? Maybe the Prayerblock?
I mean, his Beast Hunter is going to jump up there, right?
That's it. That is me done.
The sniper guards him. If he jumps up there, he's going to be seen by the sniper just standing there.
Okay. That's true.
All right, shut me up. Clearly, that's the play.
I'm not the only one who did that.
See what Steve's there.
Okay, so I've got.
I don't think you can really see it from the roofs.
I don't know what it is.
Brian, I flipped it over to kind of see a better idea of what the base looks like, and it's pretty well hidden from anything that doesn't literally climb the building.
Again, any jumping.
Right. No, I was clarifying. I wasn't certain if the Fuerbot could see him from that far distance.
Yeah.
A bit. So I just wanted to make sure.
If he goes to that back corner, probably.
Maybe. It'd be more of a case for Bran to be a half inch towards the center more.
Prowler. Nobody's looking at this area, so I can spend my impetuous order with impunity.
Yep.
Okay, so we're off to the races.
They cut from group one, expected.
We said the exact same thing there, Tim. How are you not shocked and amazed?
I mean, yeah, I don't know. I don't have answers for you. I'm tired. I had a tournament today. You've got me at half energy today.
The good news is I'm also tired. So we're on the same wavelength here. That's the goal, right? For everyone to be tired?
I mean, yeah. We'll sleep well. It'll be good evening.
So, yeah. Two orders taken from Bakunin's group one. Impetuous order on... sorry. Forco.
Well,
Forco's group one.
Foco? Forco based. I always like the shorthand Foco. But it is wrong.
I don't.
Tag you in, coach. Lobo's ready to play today.
All right, this is going to be a free for all. Lobo doesn't get any points, but he does get three Uber Fall with full Pupniks.
Mm-hmm. So, what's the over under on those Pupniks just ruining the nuns?
I mean, it really depends on how he does it, right? Just blitz the custodier and break the team entirely? Oh, no, Moiras have number two, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, never mind.
I mean, the standing template helps a lot, and having templates on multiple levels helps a lot. But Eclipse makes that not matter, right?
Yeah, drop Eclipse, and the only thing you're... Well... Cenobites and Agatha are decent, right? They might slow you down, but...
Not decent enough. Not, So, who's the priority target, then? Agatha, right? Make sure nothing gets back up, and she's the better of the two in terms of killing.
She's got two wounds, though, right? Her and the Cenobite are the hardest to take down.
Mm-hmm.
So, I might just blitz the others to get rid of more... More
I
stuff.
Guess she's also BTS6, which makes viral harder. I don't think anybody's gonna have. They're not gonna have a problem. It's just gonna be a problem for Brock.
Bran's also prone.
Oh, Bran is prone. Oh, he can't see shit. Okay, great.
There's nothing on the other side of the map, right?
Bran, if he wants to take on bloody player back over here.
You can't leave no friction in this game. It's a hard thing because right now, I have the opinion that arrows are not as strong as they should be.
Sure. I mean, yeah.
I think broadly, I would like it to feel safer to leave something up, especially if it's designed. Hey, Pathfinder's a great game.
No, Pathfinder's great. It's on the wrong side of the table. It's my own fault. It's not his fault. I'm just going to take it out on
him. Man, every time I read UFK, I think Unknown Ranger. And I realize those are the wrong. Letters.
I hate it.
Is anybody looking
Lobo wants to split, get Pupnix on the Cenobite, and the Uber, Uberfall. It's the Chimera. They're all the Uberfall.
I actually think I would put the more Pupnix on Agatha because she's BTS-6, so that you're not doing viral on her.
Yeah, they all have armor 3. The Moiras have BTS 0. And Custodier has 3 BTS. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cenobite also has 3 BTS. Yeah.
We'll see how aggressive they are. Because he's instead kind of spending orders right now on the Harris.
Right. And the way he deployed, that's not too surprising, right? He was always intending to spend orders on these guys.
Yeah, I guess.
Is his Stempler's on looking that way? Is that what he's...
Oh, I know what he's doing. So, he wants to do what you talked about, which is jump up there with the Beast Hunter.
Mm-hmm.
So he's trying to throw Eclipse in front of the Sniper.
Oh, I see.
Because like, the ground level will block the roof.
Right.
Not everybody has stealth, so arrows from Brand. Cool.
You don't know what's under there.
What's that?
You don't know what's under there.
I'm going to go ahead and throw smoke.
He could just be cheating. Okay, order on Senior Massacre. Burst 2 Eclipse grenades. Pretty likely to go off.
Doesn't matter. Yeah,
he spins 13. It's good at his job.
All right. So that's 2 dice on numbers.
I still think that instead of dealing with the sniper this way, you could instead kill the sniper with your orders.
With the Uberfall.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Just because that's way more important than killing Brandon Castro right here. Because if you kill those 5, like, really, the Bakugan list doesn't have teeth if you kill that link.
Yeah, all the guns are the Moira, the 2 Moiras.
Mm-hmm. You will have no one to soccer the ball.
Four, so I can't make it to the roof in 1 short movement skill.
No. that was never close. Why do you think that was like? Maybe I could do this thing.
He was an inch off.
Still up here.
Really, I'm going all the way to the top. It was an 8-inch move.
I thought it was 7.
Oh, of course, he threw the clips.
Yeah, it was 7. Really,
oh, no!
Okay, and then I will super jump up to here so that I'm still behind the Eclipse from Moira. But can see Brand. Cool. I'll spend a regular order.
So, 1 order to super jump and, Beast Hunter twice to get goal. On the same roof as Brand. And he's going to do a Discover shoot now, it feels like.
I can't go prone when I Discover, right? It's a movement skill, but it doesn't let me go prone.
Yeah.
Correct.
All right, I will
see what what's he actually armed with?
Panzerfaust, heavy flamethrower, and a pistol.
So even if this Discover fails, he also gets an intuitive attack.
Yep.
They're very well suited at hunting, we'll say.
Is that his actual skills?
No.
Okay, no. This is. I'm looking at a Hun doing.
Here, let me pull the profile out. and then I'll copy and paste it in.
I'll get it off.
No, I'll get models. do they still have the 2D models over here somewhere?
No.
Nope. Okay, cool. Okay. So he's
okay.
BS
cool.
11,
excellent.
13, whip 12, arm 0, BTS 0, 1 wound. He's got CC attack plus 2 damage, natural born warrior, super jump, stealth, religious, and terrain total. And then this one has Mind Layer and 18 Minds. And he has Mimetism minus 3.
There we go.
Is it this one?
Yeah, that looks like him.
Yeah, that's close enough. I think that...
That's him.
Thank you.
Cool. Natural Born Warrior.
Okay, so the stats should be correct now on the beast.
It's hunting beasts.
Yeah.
So, see, right, so what would you do? What was your response here for your brown bait?
Which brand? He's got the boarding shotgun.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just light him up.
Well,
just template. I hope you make the save. He doesn't.
You've got 2 wounds.
Oh yeah.
Do I get to see your stats?
That's very true.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, I've declared it. Sorry.
He's got 13. Does he have a +3 to dodge? Or...
No, he's just 13.
Okay. On 11s because your mimetism, or does he have mim 6 now?
No, mim.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll just shoot you.
With just a pistol?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
Yeah.
You shot him with a pistol.
19 might do it.
Cool. Well, I missed twice, so that won't do it either.
What just happened?
That's it.
Yep.
Did Brand dodge or shoot?
Spend another order in the second pool.
Tim, I can't hear you. You're muted.
Oh, there we go. I think he tried to dodge and failed.
Tried to dodge? Okay.
Yeah, he tried it on 9, and he failed on 19. Those stats are... Can you bring out the flat Brandocaster too? We'll copy those.
Ba-ba-bum-bum. Nomads.
Just quickly.
Yeah.
Can my Moira's HMG see your Beast Hunter up there?
Smoke is still...
Oh, yeah, no, you're good. Yeah, you're good.
Yeah, I think the shed is, like, this angle.
Yeah. If you move too much forward, I will see you. But, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Then you got the snipers. More, bigger problem.
Right. Okay.
Yep. Grab the wrong nomads, because that was... Whatever. Boop it a bop it a beep it a boop.
I'll dodge.
Search for Bran. Which one is it? The boarding shotgun?
Failed last time.
Oh, yeah.
That was the time to flame thrower. I'll do a pistol again.
Okay. Thank you. 14. Fuck you, Bran. Same roll.
Okay.
What did you dodge on? 13?
I will.
Okay, it should be accurate now.
Yeah, there we go.
And I'll just go ahead and move. Let me just
make sure. In the melee?
I'm moving prone.
All right, so they bounced on their next engagement. I heard they both rolled 14s.
So it's not stupid, but
no, they didn't.
Yeah, so I'll just
what? You. So okay. Brand failed, and he's. I'm confused. What just happened?
They shot pistols again, and nothing happened because he failed the dodge, and he also missed because he's bad at shooting because he has mimetism.
Anyway,
it's shock now.
Okay, he's dead.
Flamethrower on the save. That's one wing, no meeting cap.
Oh. All right, so they finally did what they should have done at the beginning.
Well, I mean,
flamethrower Bran.
Oh, that was all group 2 orders? That's okay. Interesting.
That took 4 orders.
Wild. All group 2, though. But yeah.
Wild.
Well, because it was what? Jump up once, jump up twice, discover.
That's
shoot,
so.
Move. Yeah.
Well, in any case, Beast Hunter took out Brand. Brand took out Beast Hunter. And now they're dating.
And now they go and Noki's
into your side of the table. That gets me.
Do they have classifieds for this or no?
They should.
Right.
Yeah, they have classifieds.
What are they?
Let me turn to the all-seeing eye.
He's so powerful, behold.
Oh, does that not let me see their hand? Lame. Oh, no, it does, right here. So, red side has extreme prejudice, which is foreign company. And then blue has nano espionage.
I think that your Moiras cannot see in this area.
Yeah.
I'd have to come out.
Yeah, so I might be able to see. Like.
I'm worried that he doesn't realize the opportunity he has with the Uberfall.
I mean, he already moved him out, right?
That was just their Impetuous.
Oh, that was just the Impetuous.
Like,
yeah.
I'm just thinking he's... Because now he's moving... Like, I understand that the Bolt is an easier gun to apply a lot of the time. But that Uberfall is so primed to just tear them in half.
Right, because he spent one order setting up smoke, and now he's spending another moving out with this Harris.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe he's just trying to play soccer, right? Like,
but like, I don't know. If you play a faction with Uberfalls, you need to be used to going for the throat, right? That's like the benefit of that unit. It's fast, and arguably is the hardest to stop in the game, in terms of like what you have to put in its way.
Mm-hmm.
You have to put like a combination of like templates and shooters and. It's not as simple as, like, you can't just put one guy up there to watch. They're too fast and too consistent with their smoke, and for all the reasons that they're good. They are terrifying. Yeah, you should... But you can't say that. Not right now. You shouldn't be on this side of the map. Go on the other side of the map. What are you doing?
What are you talking about?
Oh,
the Uberfall.
Yeah, he's... The guy moving the bolt just said, God, Chimeras are so terrifying. I'm like, yes, they should be. Go do your thing.
Yeah, so with all this end of round scoring, if you're going first, you're not gonna.
And then is it a short skill or a full order to activate the console?
Just a short skill.
Okay. It's a full order to.
Although it is funny that you could line it up in such a way where, say, you had 10 orders and you went. You did the rotating special. No, sorry. The consoles don't have the rotating specials thing. That's just, you can only hit a console once until they. Okay. You know, for a moment, I thought you could go and have the soccer team. Everybody hits the console, then everyone hits the soccer ball and just like carry it away.
Pinata, everyone's in a line. No, the thing you can do is set up a line of people 4 inches apart and soccer ball it between them.
Wouldn't that be fun?
It seems like too much effort, but...
I disagree.
I will spend another order.
The reason it seems like two... I guess if it's on your side already, then sure.
Yeah.
But once you start kicking it into the other side, having that many units that deep...
Lobo, I'm entertained by your matter-of-fact stating it like you're like the StarCraft computer who like announces like you're out of minerals. It's like he has spent too many orders for the UFC to be effective. It's like just the voice of God is declared.
He said that before. I didn't think he realized that was group 2 orders on the Beast Hunter.
Well, no, he gave a warning earlier where he's like, but now he didn't say it until now. These are all group 1 orders that he's spending. So I think it's contextual.
He said this before the Beast Hunter was done moving.
I thought it was if he spends more than one. It'll be too many. And then he declared just now, it's now too many.
Yeah.
I'm crazy.
It was right. Yeah, that's fine. Cool.
The point is, I think everybody in the chat was surprised that they didn't just use the Uberfall.
Did he move the beacon?
I think he's trying to. Yeah, he shoved it 2 inches.
Okay.
Towards the opponent, because that's where you want it, right? So he went up to the box, went, And then backed up. Yeah, Lobo is how 9,000. That's not wrong. Right, I can't.
So he's done the bare minimum to force Bakunin player to have to kick it back to his side. Right?
Yeah. That's my first short skill arrow. Unbeknownst to him, there's a prowler ready to go.
Yeah, there's a prowler right by that button. There's just that link team that can delete his chimera.
Hey, Clint or Tim, whoever put the token up there, I'm Orko.
Ah!
Also, I don't think there's anything really to do with activating it. Other than
if you've pushed the button last, you can't push it again.
Right. Yeah.
That's all I'm marking here.
Not that you couldn't. Come on. You don't say that out loud.
He was doing the mission. I mean, I don't hate that. I do hate that that's probably not the right play.
Yeah.
But I don't hate that that's where his focus is.
Well, don't forget she can decline from there.
Yeah.
Right. So she'll be up.
I'm not going to lie. I'm very excited to watch people play this with reinforcements. It's going to be funny.
Reinforcements exists. I don't know.
We'll see. I can't tell until I've seen it at a bigger event. I'm excited.
Cool. Arrows.
I'm gonna light up that pop neck.
Oh shit. You have a line of fire there.
So his HMG is watching this the circle zone. Which I don't hate using the HMG as a arrow.
Yeah. That's fine. I just... Over the sniper, though?
Oh, he got hit to... Not over the sniper, in addition to...
But it's not... He's not doing it in addition to. Like, the sniper's so far to the side.
The sniper is staying over here. He had to throw smoke for it.
But that's... Alright, well...
It's two separate arrows he's doing it in addition to.
Oh, that's...
I hate it.
That's okay, also fine.
That's
but...
it. I think you can just move 2 inches there. Yeah, you got total cover there. Yeah.
He made the saves.
He made the two saves. Yeah, he got hit twice by the HMG and then rolled 2 17s for the armor saves, and now he's failing guts.
Chimera's dodge.
That's
succeeds. And
cool.
Then Pupnik's, I'll go like next left and then next left.
Yep. Good.
Succeeds.
All right, so everybody but his Pupnik that was in the face-to-face made their dodge.
Oh, well, at least he's got all the bloody armor. And don't forget they dodged.
Man, I am so disappointed with the new Uberfall.
Really? Yeah, let me bring him up. I want to take a peek.
So the Chimera is going to dodge prone and then really tuck up right in.
Like...
Here we are. Okay. Looking at them now. Why is that disappointing you?
I like the shark guy, and that's it.
What's wrong with the whip?
Huh?
Like, what's wrong with the new main commander lady?
The weird half-naked furry abs thing?
I guess. What's wrong with... I don't... Are the abs are the problem?
Yeah.
I disagree. I think they're fine.
Yeah, but it's also...
They're weird and it looks terrible.
You have to control too if you don't want to.
Yeah, but...
I mean, is that any better than... The one that exists now where she's, like, flexing over her whip behind her back?
She's holding her whip behind her back. It's fine.
It's a good model. I'm entertained by the cat. The cat's funny.
Yeah.
It's not the greatest. The cat one is not perhaps not great. The shark is good, and the ram is great. But
the problem with the ram is you already have a ram in the old ones. I don't know.
Kind of climb up the wall.
And it, I
like the whip on the new one a lot.
Sure, I don't hate the whip.
As you walk around the corner.
And I like totally the abs, even. Like, I think it's a good look.
On the wall, you'll be
sticking out. That's weird. I know it's supposed to be a reference to Beerus from DBZ.
Is it supposed to, or is it just a skinless cat? Because that's all it is. All
right, I'm going to send you... It's the same color in the art. Like,
I know who Beerus is.
All right.
Last regular order. Oh, no, you did. Last regular order will be...
So where is he at now? His Uberfall tucked in a bit. He needs to stand up with his security. No, he doesn't, because he's going to get outranged by the sniper. Yeah, taking out that sniper in HMG would have been my first choice.
I still consider the crackback from Bakunin now. With the nuns kind of free, they're going to be able to... I guess there's not really many people doing Overwatch. So the nuns won't be directly useful in that fashion.
No, but then you have the same exact problem where you have an Uberfall ready to just run down the middle then.
And yeah, they're going to come kill your Harris.
And that'll take out your, or the five man, right? Either or.
I think the Harris is easier just because of proximity.
It's harder because of the senior massacre.
First we'll get you there. I mean, you could also just shoot Senior Massacre if you wanted, but I get you. Like, you can outburst Senior Massacre, since you have...
Okay, well, now that... his HMG is staying prone. So his HMG is watching a little bit, maybe, between that...
Ooh, I like that positioning, actually. It's completely hidden from the nuns, but is doing great Overwatch with the Uberfall.
I don't know about great. They could just go down the middle.
They have to go prone. Like, if they're standing and they go through, he can see over the car if you're standing way down there.
Oh, can he? Okay. Well, no, he's prone.
Right. I think what I mean is against the wall over here, like, in my mind, the Uberfall were going to cut forward and left.
If they cut forward and right, then he doesn't see them, is what I'm saying.
But also, he's not approaching direct line. Like, eventually he would see them, though, when they're going for Massacre. He's covering Massacre, and that's a good thing, because I guess what I'm saying.
Sure.
Okay, so that was my first short skill.
His Fearbok looks like he's also kind of looking off diagonally to the right.
Yeah, he's got a different angle, but both of those would be covered by one eclipse, so I think that's the problem.
Yeah, you mean that spot the eclipse is currently in?
Yes. I'm curious where... the Crocman is. That's the X factor in all this. Is a Crocman just shows up and puts a mine down and is like, ah!
Your sniper. Not right now. No. The sniper has to move.
Okay, so he's still positioning them. Yeah, he's still prone, but he moved over some, so he... I don't know that helps him at all. And then, his HMG moved.
Cool. Mm-hmm. Cool. Okay. Yep. My fire team is moved, and I suppose that is me.
All right, so we are at the bottom of round one. Bakunin's turn. The ball is on their side of the field. But
the thing is that
pretty
one
easily
pushes
rectifiable.
It's enough. Kind of. One guy can only push it once, and then you have to hit a button. I guess you could combine the Stempler with the Prowler to get two pushes.
So you only need... If you get someone to the beacon, you only need one, because it's 4 inches.
It's 4, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you get to a beacon, you actually pull 6 towards the middle and it'll go past.
That's not towards the middle. It would just go to the middle.
Oh, right, because it's not like a shove, I'm thinking. It's
you move it until it's touching the middle. Okay. But in my mind, for a moment, I was playing Marvel the Crisis Protocol. It's like, if it says move something 6 inches towards the middle, it will overshoot. Because it's like, you said 6 inches that way.
Sure. Yeah, move the tracking beacon up to 6 inches towards the center.
Okay.
Dang. I really would have preferred it going bing, bing, bing.
So I feel like Kevin's been a little less prominent on the podcast. Is he stepping back a little bit?
Yeah, but it's also just like giving him a break.
Yeah.
He did a lot of stuff.
And now they're talking about their podcasts.
Kevin.
Kevin.
You're almost Kevin.
There's a... I've been,
all right, let's see.
You know, you don't
we have a first-time chat from Jaga. 8, 5, 9. So, new to Nomads, what's the best way to cross the field to Uberfall Commando? Is it to just drop Eclipse as you cross, since the Chimera doesn't dodge well? Or do you just dodge your way across? What's the Chimera dodge on? Is it just
14.
Air quotes just 13?
Or yeah, 13. Sorry.
Okay. So I think the big thing is that whenever you set out to use a bunch of orders on a Chimera, you need to plan where you expect to need Eclipse before you start. That a lot of times you'll be able to, if you think that the eventual issue will actually be further on your path, you can like long bomb an Eclipse and just hope you get lucky while you're moving the six each time. Alternatively, if you can find a different path around, it's all based on looking at what is your goal, how many orders do you guesstimate it'll take, and what are the problems in the way. And so like when we were looking at the Bakunin deployment, we noticed that there was nothing really watching the path between the Uberfall and their objective, which was the link team. And so we were expecting them to just kind of shove. So that's kind of the first thing you look at is, could my Uberfall get there without much opposition? Because like if there's an ARO that only takes like 2 Eclipse grenades to get past, a lot of times that's enough to just kind of zip past a gap. It's always going to be contextual though. There's not like a tribe to like, if this is X, then Y push your Uberfall.
Then...
So it looks like we have impetuous movement on a Morlock here.
Morlock is pushing.
What did he roll?
Well,
oh yeah, that's a good question.
What did your Morlocks roll?
So this Morlock rolled 6-4 and super jump. This Morlock rolled Climbing Plus. It's on my little card over here.
Yeah, I'm gonna change their name.
Oh yeah, go for it. Oh, I can do that.
Okay, that'll be simpler so that we can just like highlight and remember.
Yeah.
Did you change their name?
I said he would.
Oh, there it is. Yes.
6-4 is a hell of a thing.
There's a lot of increased movement on that chart.
Yeah.
I could like throw a smoke and punch a pub nigger. Mainly I just get control of that if I can succeed at doing it.
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, let's do it.
You have now graduated beyond the I shoot it until it dies school of infinity, which is a popular school. It's a good school. But eventually it does have to go.
Oh, there they are.
Yes, let's force real quick.
Just I'm not gonna be able to
so throwing some smoke with his impetuous order on his Morlock,
yeah.
So he could contest the controlling of the console.
Ooh, it's with an 8. Yeah,
so Pando's not that hard. You only need to be whip 12. It's easy. If it touches you, you're correct.
Yep, go for it.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, I'll take a dodge. It's at -3, but 16 is still pretty good.
3
is great. Do I want to be anywhere else? Probably not.
I feel like you might consider jumping into, like,
Are you trying to avoid the fight with the Morlock? Probably, because he would beat the crap out of a Pupnik.
Yep. Pupniks by themselves are not great. CC 19. That's all they got.
Which is good enough for a lot of things, but not for a Morlock.
He's just trying to get in the way of the Morlock, it looks like.
Yeah. They are 1 point. That's very fair. That's very fair.
Yep. I was not saying they were miscasted. I was just saying they're going to lose the fight.
I mean, it comes back to that question that we had at the beginning of, like, moderators are 9 points, but is that better than a Quangxi? It's like, I don't think so. There's different.
Sure, but I think if you jump over that, I think
there you go. I balanced.
Oh, that HMG move. Yep. Interesting. Oh, I see, because the middle building blocks the line of fire to the nuns. So he's actually feeling comfortable standing with the...
Oh, he stood. I missed the part that he stood.
Yeah, he hadn't done that when we were talking about this. That's a much better spot.
I told you he moved, but I did not realize he stood up.
He had not moved yet, I don't think.
You just weren't paying attention.
No, I was looking at him when he was here.
All right. Play the video back. It was...
Check
I don't know.
The tapes.
So it looks like he's probably going to forego his Chimera's Impetuous, and now he's checking his Morlock on the left. I do like that his Impetuous Smoke Throwers are kind of sprinkled. He's got a Morlock on the left, a Morlock on the right, and the Uberfall in the middle.
It's a good move. I definitely, in my games today, I definitely wish that I had had a second Varangian. I got really greedy and only took one. I was like, I... wish I had smoke. Carabots are hard if you don't have your if you're on a sniper.
What are hard?
Bots.
Bots.
I took a fight with my Pure Link Kappa sniper. We both crit each other, and the flash pulse got a from a war core hit me at like 40 inches and stunned me. I was like, God fucking.
Now spend Chimera as a regular order.
But for a moment, I was very excited to crit on a 15. That dynamic lighting going on from that lantern. Spooky Pupnik shadows.
That's how you know it's a Vol map. There's a ton of random lighting for some reason.
Hey, lighting's great. Make use of the video.
1.5 to there. Then...
Lighting is fine. A giant beacon.
Oh, it's just a lantern.
Okay, so he's now using his irregular order to move his Chimera up so he doesn't get shot by the Securitat.
What is the right way to say that word? Is it Securitate or Securitate or like what is the like correct way to say that?
I don't even know what language it is.
Are you based on it being Tunguska? My gut.
That makes no sense. Wait, who is in Tunguska? That's just like bank people. It's not even.
They're Russian. I guess I'll take that shot. Let's see. Security.
Romanian is where the word comes from. So I have no idea.
No. Yeah, it's a Soviet style secret police. All right. Interesting. It was dissolved in 1989 because I guess it was bad.
Matters, but yeah, dodge on the Chimera. Cool, dodge on. I don't know.
They're certainly fast.
I'm gonna get to the right.
I guess he does. He's probably just going to.
Ram and Tiger.
Alright,
so
Ram. It's probably gonna cost some extra order to put an Eclipse here, yeah.
Cool, Tiger dodging.
Or I guess he could dodge past the gap if he wants to risk it. Risky for Biscay.
He seems to have lost a Pupnik, and I'm not quite sure how.
I believe that the machine gun saw it as it crossed the back line.
Oh, it came from somewhere else. Gotcha.
Yeah,
gotcha.
It came from the right of his going left.
Okay.
Hum, hum, hum.
Hey, did you see him there? Otherwise, I just pulled him back.
He dodged here, and I feel like he should have smoked.
Yeah, just accept that Pupnik dies if the HMG hits it, and just get the smoke down. Don't waste orders. You're more interested in an order than your 1 point Pupnik.
Yeah.
Three.
If I can save a point and I just take two Pupniks, I do. That one's always just
a good one. Securitate is the wiki pronunciation.
Securitate.
And I'm not sure if I'm reading it how it's meant, because. It still just has T-A-T-E, which, I don't know.
You know what? Let's just see how this goes.
Pronunciation. What does Google say?
Going to figure out.
Yeah, it's saying Securitate. Interesting. Okay. All right. Securitate, it is. Which was, I don't think, any of my...
okay, what we'll do, regular order on the...
I mean, moving the HMG was a great move. In terms of just, like, causing problems for the Bakuden player?
Sure.
I wonder if there's any case to be made for trying to...
Just hop his reverence to the left and shooting it?
Yeah. Or even right. Like, just go... You could shotgun brute force these Pupniks and then just, like, shoot kind of laterally left and then back up. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I wouldn't want to move my five. When you have the long range superiority, I would want to keep them in the back, was the only thing.
Like, it's also a flexible team that fights up close well. That's kind of what I like about it.
So, yeah, but that's not where his advantage is, right? Like, the other side can fight up close also.
Motorcycles and remotes.
I would like you to say it one more time.
Impetuous models can cautious move.
Oh, yeah. Tags, remotes, vehicles, and troopers and motorcycles can never declare it.
That sounds right.
Yeah, but I believe you can.
Okay. Yeah.
It's just a type thing.
Yeah, that makes this a lot easier.
Yeah, Sukun's cautious is good there, and I understand like the hesitance, but I also feel like if you get rid of that Pupnik. The Foco player does not have the same ability to crack back out at your five man if you're defensively postured. If you just back up after you take your two targets.
Which I did. Nice.
Like if you make sure you kill the Uberfall and then maybe put some shots downrange at the HMG to clear up a pace, then you like back the team up to the car and the space to the left and just like position around here. I don't know exactly what Foco would do because they have to go across the map with any of their like powerful dangerous things.
I mean, you're not gonna get all the way around here, fight the Fearbok, fight the HMG, fight the Pupnik and the Chimera. Because if you don't get the Chimera, it just comes around and gets you.
So I think that you start with the HMG, which you can. Funnily enough, you can climb on the car.
Oh, sorry, the Fearbox prone. Box.
Yeah, the Fearbok is not fighting.
Yeah, okay. Never
mind. With the Fearbok, sure. Maybe a bit harder. But I think that once you kill the HMG, you can just shove the Vulcan shotgun up to the Chimera.
Yeah.
Morlock is punching a Pupnik.
Turns out she's good at it. Don't try the same thing against her its leader.
Aeros, Pupnik. Other
yeah, I guess I'll just oppose you. We'll just, because I'm CC 19,
16.
You're 20 something. 16 versus 26. Yeah. Morlock rolled a 12 total.
Okay.
And the.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't do great either.
Failed.
6, so double action on Fizz 6, 15, I think.
Pupnik's gone.
I think there could be a case for it's funny, a intuitive attack would be a more effective way to do a template to kill the chimeras than a normal chain rifle would.
So I can stand up and go straight.
Like, if he just, like, uses his order to move in the smoke to go see the chimera and then just intuitive attacks it, like, that's better than just chain rifling.
We'll do the same roll.
Yeah, I don't hate that. Although he could just... Yeah, you're fine with that trade. Super fine.
Bastard.
Although the engineer is right there, yeah.
The same number, too.
There's a clockmaker right here. So you have to watch out for that.
But that's a lot of orders wasted. You don't get your impetuous or your regular, like...
We can do it again.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lobo brings up a good point. The pupnik should still be there. They have total immunity.
Okay, so one wound. It is unconscious.
Same difference.
Oh. And a whole bunch of cracks.
They have an engineer, but they're wounds. So.
Oh, actually,
The Bakken player, they're leaving enough orders to actually go and, like,
grenade, which is annoying.
Kick the can.
Because I want to spend it to get her onto the point.
I honestly have no idea what they're doing.
She's just going to go here onto the point.
I reiterate, I like the intuitive play. If he does that and it works, it'd be fucking genius. I'd love it.
Dodge with the, just in case.
Yeah. Oh, I suppose, can I see the other, can I see that back pupnik? I guess I can, can't I?
Yeah, you might be able to get a line of fire to that.
Oh, yeah, I'll push out to see that back pupnik.
Cool.
And, yep, my heroes.
Dodge.
Wait, doesn't he see both?
I guess I'll just pistol you. There's not much point in doing anything else. Yeah, I guess I'll just pistol you.
Okay. I feel like you see both of them.
That's up to them.
So, within 8, so that's 14s, 2 on 14s.
One.
I guess they're also not as familiar with the TTS.
Yeah, 2 hits.
Cool. Yeah, Prowler would be the play. I don't want to see him. Like, it needing to be a specialist is a very unique kind of requirement for this.
Hold on one sec. I accidentally deleted something.
Ruh-roh.
This got moved to the sky for some reason.
Go, my people need me.
So, Pupnik in the back went unconscious.
Yep. We're running out of puppers. One by one, he's losing points. Like, literally one by one. I guess there's what? Oh, this is the DA one, so it doesn't have an assault pistol, does it?
Correct.
Right, yeah. That hurts.
In a regular order.
Again, it makes sense because of mind wipe, but not an assault pistol here would be pretty good.
Mm-hmm. It does not look like he's going to be able to kick the can.
He has to use the Prowler. The Prowler is in a great position to do it. Is it in group one? Or two. I never ended up getting the list, so I have to ask you.
It's group one.
So, the Prowler could do it. It only takes one kick, right? So
he has to get there.
But he's right there.
Awesome.
He's right here, and he's 4-4.
Two orders.
Cautious move, I guess.
Yeah, but he's got five.
Yeah.
Six.
Counts like a...
Yeah.
What, a boarding shotgun, right?
Okay. So I don't do anything.
Hmm?
Boarding
shotgun,
right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'd love to kill that HMG. I'm just wondering whether it's probably not worth my time.
Yeah, let me just pop up the lists again.
What's
the
massacre again? What is he?
Here's
Bakunin list. And they're talking about
is actually a crapshoot if it's the Chimera and Pupnik in close combat against each other. I think your numbers are slightly better because you're -3.
Mm.
But my CC is 24. So you'll be you're up by 3 on it. So it'll be my 21 to your 24. He's got EM close combat weapon, and then he's got a breaker combi rifle, eclipse grenades. And regeneration.
You know what I think you do?
Hmm.
Because Senior Massacre is prone, so he doesn't actually see past the objective.
Just getting a
if
right,
you're prone, sure.
Top of everything else.
So I like the idea of the Chimera walking into that room, tossing Eclipse to blocks in your massacre, and she's walking over and killing the bolt and set up.
Sure.
Just be like, you know what? Not Dillahoo, you're good at kicking ass. I don't want any part of that.
You could do some Eclipse and not roll 19s and then get there.
Yeah. Start with the Prowler. Just walk the Prowler up, kick the button, and then do what you can with. Like, make sure the objective gets done, right?
That wouldn't get the objective done, though. That would only get it back to center.
No, it only moved two.
Correct. Because pushing
the
button
would be four. So it's
you're getting the Prowler to the actual thing.
Yeah, I'm not going to the button. Just go kick the can.
Damn perfect. It's under control.
It's under control. That's how I'm going to say it every time now.
Okay, I'll do it.
It's under control.
Yep.
Do you mind if I check my zone of control? Spider,
please. Now, was that eight? Is that the eight I measured?
Yeah, because it's an inch long template, so if you're hitting the edge of it, 7.5 is perfect.
Yeah, okay, cool. Okay. I'll move all the up the pubnicks, I guess, behind her. I mean, they may as well be up. There you go.
Can I use that? Yeah, you can use whatever you want, man.
15, does it?
Unless it's tabletop throwdown, long and extended. Actually, you know what? Go ahead and use that. I don't care. But only if it's not infinity related.
I just saw this great koala art on the side of that.
Actually, you know what?
The wall here.
Yeah, he's gonna stand up.
That's funny. Love it.
So I believe if you walk out,
koala would be good here. Oh, he's standing now.
Oh, he dodged zone of control. Sure. So it looks like the Chimera got down some smoke. Senior Massacre stood. And is ready to say, hey, you.
Yeah, no.
Get off of my cloud.
Off you go. Yeah, cautious. Would you still?
No. They can't cautious move. They're too close.
A polite reminder, the cautious move does not work within 8. You have to have stealth to do that.
Oh, I don't have that, do I?
Yeah. Just before you start measuring things.
That's alright. I mean, it's all the same if I just throw another grenade anyway.
So what's funny is he could walk a Pupnik forward to have Senior Massacre see it. If he shoots the Pupnik, just run through with everything else. If he doesn't, just run all your Pupniks through and leave your Chimera behind.
Kind of, but that doesn't change that eventually you need the Chimera close enough to do Kung Fu over there. Like you have to get the Pupnik across the gap.
Not if you just kill Senior Massacre doing that.
Sure.
Yeah, so it's just going to move out. Four.
Is that consistent? Yeah. Oh, right, because you... I gotta say, I really dislike that you don't have to choose the combat.
Is this the killer hacker?
The one who's gonna do the kung fu.
I've got no arrows.
So we've got the camo, we got the prowler moving up, it looks like.
Yeah.
He's like, I should probably. Oh, but he's doing the. No!
He's doing the button. I could just feel it.
No!
I don't feel like.
Why does it.
Yeah, does anything see the butt? Nope. Nothing sees the ball. Yeah, he should have definitely kicked it. Do you know what a Scotsman and the Doors have in common?
Let's just get rid
no
of
idea.
The problem, and then we can punt it. Alright, regular order. Chimera is going to poke out again, just to see the ground before
the Nazi massacre.
Yeah, so like there.
What could be better?
If I threw a smoke, would it touch him?
From there? It's hard to say. It's pretty close. I mean, I'll get a dodge either way. Because you're within 8 inches. So I'll have an out-of-line-of-fire dodge, whether it's...
The doors say, hey, you get off my cloud. A Scotsman says, hey, McLeod, get off my...
I don't know what I'm worried about. I'll throw another smoke.
What is that word?
I'm guessing it's a pronunciation of a Scottish word because that's what they do.
Oh, you. Yes, like sheep. Got it.
Yep, same roll.
Oh, yeah, that's funny.
Cool. Eight.
Yeah. I got it. I saw Uwu at first and was like, not sure that tracks.
12 fails because it's out of line of fire.
Yep. Okay.
Are we.
Now we get a bit more freedom to move up.
Okay, so we spent another order on the Chimera to get some smoke down. And he's probably going after.
So we're going to go.
I mean, he could kind of do both, right?
Nine, and then
he's running out of orders.
Beautiful.
Pupniks are going to go. Yeah. Same.
Like, he could just send two at each, funnily enough, right?
Yeah, he could. Oh, yeah. He definitely could.
Oh, sorry. There's only three. One of them died.
Then he definitely could not.
I.
But well, you send two Pupniks at Massacre.
I just wonder if he forgot that the HMG is still just watching Massacre.
Yeah, I'm going to go.
I guess the smoke will cover him, huh?
Yeah.
Can I get over there? Oh, I can.
Yeah.
But stay in the. Oh, actually, hold on. Before I move her. Gonna move the Pupniks.
He's gonna sacrifice a Pupnik to do
actually,
this.
Actually, no. If you dodge into CC, I still get an order to do it. So yeah, makes it
yeah.
Yeah. So we'll do that. So,
is he just gonna do the 1v1 here?
I mean, I respect it.
Oh, 4 inches.
Okay. You know what? It doesn't bloody matter.
Okay, no.
You get the dodge anyway.
Now, if you want style
are
points,
you getting into
you
CC?
Also walk onto the
no,
wall.
I'll push it back in a second. I'll
and, like, jump him up there from
no,
the
no,
top
no,
of the cylinder.
There's a gap there, but I just wasn't sure if it was intentional.
No, I couldn't get that close.
If you were engaged from the top of your silhouette
yeah, I'll go ahead
and you took a hit,
a
when you're engaged, can you go prone?
You cannot guts, no.
Right? Yeah, that was
yeah.
It's the same reason you can't just
two,
walk 2 inches away.
I am going to go prone.
Mm-hmm.
And.
I feel like the kind of thing where it's like.
What do I want
he feels like this? He knows what he needs to do, but it's like getting away from him.
Because you have both consoles at this point. So me standing on the console doesn't do anything. If I dodge 4 inches.
Does standing on the console normally do something?
Still gonna be able to get
if you control at least one, you get a point at the end of the round.
Oh, interesting.
Slightly more annoying to do it.
But because he's got the one on this side, it doesn't matter, and he's touching this one, he can't control it.
But I would not
so Bakunin has full points there.
Yeah.
He's gonna lose the point for the ball being on his side if it doesn't get moved. And nobody's touching the ball. Someone needs to touch the ball.
Massacre just jumped away.
Choices, maybe.
I love it.
Cool. The Chimera just got yeeted. Was that you?
No.
Yeah, I just flipped the order then. Wait. I was gonna say, where did my Chimera go?
That's so funny.
It got flicked over here somehow. I don't know.
Yeah, all right,
bye. Pretty sure it was Tim.
Cowboy, your
hey, I'll be right back. Give me a moment.
Okay.
We're just gonna have a break and party.
Okay, now he's just.
Yeah.
So after all this finickiness, he's just running out in front of Massacre.
Yeah.
Bad news bears, he's not shock immune. So I'll go ahead and close combat your Chimera.
Yep, cool. I will close combat you as well.
Alright, I'm gonna fish for that crit. Come on, 19 or 20. Mwah, you hit me before. Let's go.
Oh, 19, yes.
I did not.
so that's full hit.
Two viral. Right? Or which one is the viral? Or oh no, it's only her. It's only her.
Yeah,
it's like what, 7 saves?
Yeah, 6-7.
Yeah, 7 saves. On your
I think he's gonna die.
ATS.
Oh man, that first 19 and 18 showed up, and I was hopeful, but no, he's gone.
That was. I looked at. I was like, "What the fuck? Oh my god!"
All right, Massacre got massacred. Chimera
like,
wrecked him.
No,
in that fight, I would not have gone against the Chimera. I would have gone against one of the Pupniks, because
well, 13, then
You're gonna lose against the Chimera.
You get plus two damage for the two.
I mean, you're probably going to lose against the Pupnik also, but if
yeah,
you might get a free Pupnik if you go after the Pupnik.
Alert, fist 13,
yeah, it's,
so he's,
yeah, it's 14.
He's all gone.
You were close. You were real close.
Yeah.
You rolled two 11s and he's, what, BTS 3?
Yeah.
That was real close.
Yeah. All right. Cool.
Now he's got two orders to try and take out. Maybe the Bolt and... Avicenna?
Okay, we're going to...
I think you put the two Pupniks on Avicenna and Chimera on the Bolt.
Going to move 4 inches with this camo marker.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing can see it, right? Nope. So the Pupnik's like all the way up the top, isn't it?
The Pupnik is on the ground.
Sorry, not the Pupnik. The Pupnik's dead. The Chimera is all the way like up the top.
Right. Yeah, nobody will see you.
Yeah, cool. And I'm going to, reveal the Prowler.
Cool. Killer Hacker or Specialist?
Killer Hacker, yeah.
Cool.
And I'm going to try and press the button.
Beautiful.
So we're getting a button push from the Prowler now.
This, do I?
I don't think this one has me.
I think it was only in the other one.
Yeah.
Really wish it. Would be cool if you did.
I have no idea where that Chimera is. They talked about it, but they both agreed it didn't see. I think it climbed up somewhere. I think it's like maybe
as far as points go, it's better off
up here.
Walks onto the console. I'm already controlling that console.
But I'm not sure. They talked about it and they both agreed it couldn't see.
Yeah.
So
okay, yeah, no, it's better off that he just walks onto the console. I'm sure I'm gonna do, yeah, cool. Sorry, I'm just doing his zone of control.
Yeah.
That. Yep, all right.
Pushing the button.
That does work. Okay, no, I can do that. Okay, yep, all right, yep. So, didn't put the order. Last order in this pool.
Cool.
He's going to, just move. Hold on. Mr. HMG. Oh, no, if I'm on the far side, you can't see me. Okay. I just kind of go on that side of the beacon.
Yeah.
Cool.
So he's kind of given up his Prowler at this point. He's just going to be out in the wind touching the
That's not what I wanted. One.
Button.
No, I think you're all clear.
Cool. Going to go to there.
Fantastic.
But he is going to get the point for touching it. He is not going to get the point.
He's got an extra inch.
I turned.
Can I go?
The Prowler eventually ended up touching the thing.
No, it's too far
in. He failed at pushing the button over here and is just touching it now.
And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use.
Did
my
you kick him the can?
Cool.
Oh, I forgot you could do that.
And
so he used his command token to spend another
4 inches onto your side.
Did you clarify that you couldn't do that at the start?
No. He can do that.
Cool.
The tactical usage of command tokens is not done during the tactical phase.
Cool.
Best I can do.
All right.
Last thing.
This is exactly what I want to see Otoho Proceeds used for. Right? Like, this is the kind of order I want to see.
Sure. So he spent an entire order moving the track and beacon on the other side. This did not gain him any points, but it did take one away from his opponent.
Do I want to do anything else with any of them?
No, interesting question.
Yeah, I guess that will poke out more.
Can the tracking beacon move through models?
Around me. But I don't really want to.
What do you think?
I will look it up. The fact that it requires a path makes
and,
me.
And the link team leader will be.
Suspect
the,
no, but.
I guess the HMG.
Oh, I'm not looking at B-Pong. Where's
B-Pong? Yeah, I like the idea that you surround Domaru and they just dodge and say, you can't move this ball. It's our ball. Stay away.
It's going to be all she wrote. Yep.
Okay.
That's it.
Cool. Did I delete my order for?
I don't see anything that says that units stop it.
Okay. Side note. I'm looking forward to seeing some deployments where people deploy a line of specialists if they're going first. Like they're setting up the conga line?
Exclusion zone, right?
Yeah, right, no. But like in their deployment, and then they run people into the exclusion zone to get out. kicks would it take to get it? It would be take three kicks to get it into your deployment.
Yeah.
And you could deploy people at 16.
You're kicking it the other way. You're kicking it towards your enemy.
That was so much work.
Oh, that's so much less fun.
You know, you got the momentum.
It'd be so funny to just yeet.
It's soccer, not keep away. I don't know.
Ah, you're right. It's not capture the flag. So see, senior masker died when I was gone.
Right.
Yep.
No, just like I was sweating.
See how there's three things here, and there's nothing in the middle of them.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
So the HMG didn't hit anybody.
Okay. So 2 points to you. So I.
Or did they dodge past the line of fire?
You know what? I don't even know if they took that shot. I don't think they took that shot because of the smoke.
I think actually the angle. Look at the angle on the HMG. I think so actually it might have just missed it. It's
yep.
Tight.
All right, so Bakunin has the 2 points: one for having the ball on their enemy side, one for touching at least one of the consoles.
Sorry.
And we are at the top of two.
I never. Yep. I'm assuming.
Second pool is Clockmaker 0, Pathfinder, and then Beast Hunter.
He did just say the zero. Yeah. That's great.
No, it's literally the only.
I love that.
Yeah. I don't.
Did the Prowler, was it not seen by the Chimera? Yeah.
So, Lobo asked this exact same thing. I'm thinking, and they said it didn't see, and I heard something about it being up. I think it's up here. Like.
Oh, I hate that. Okay, excellent. All right, continue.
With its climbing plus.
Yeah.
So.
I guess that's legal. Also dislike.
Just hanging like a bat off the eaves there.
All
right. I mean, wildly thematic, so I guess I can't be mad. How often do you think that the Dragon Beacon will just be like an inch over the center?
Why does Forco have a point, Lobo?
What's the scoring?
Right. So 2-0. There are three things that happened at the end of the round. Nobody's touching it, so that one doesn't count. The ball moved 4 inches, so it's back on Forco's side, so Bakunin got that point. And the only one touching a thing is also Bakunin.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, okay.
Take that back. I'm not.
Sorry, that was a lot more aggressive than I meant at Lobo. I just
what the fuck?
I just wanted to make sure I wasn't missing something.
It's fine. I'll pair you guys round one.
Not
and
ammo, is it?
Do not force pairs. I hate that.
Okay.
So stupid.
Yeah, let's do this. I want to kill.
But what if you wanted to play with the guy and you haven't seen him in years?
Then I'll play with him before or after.
Oh, people don't have that time.
Senna is going to move out of line of sight.
Then he didn't really want to play with me that bad, so it's fine.
Oh.
Going to cover over here. And
it'll be really funny if it just happens, though.
And out of line of fire.
Sure.
Yeah. But now I have Pulsar. Yeah, that's the best.
Okay, so his bolt and Avicenna spent an order tucking behind this crate.
I'm just gonna get clip smoke, to be honest.
Yeah, smoke's probably correct here, only because the bolt is already resilient to a nanopulsar. You're not gonna win the face to face. And Avicenna can just get the bolt up. You know what I mean?
Alright, three hits.
I believe 14. 9.
You're 116 versus 4 dice? Right. Nah, I would have nanopulsared.
But, like, the bolts are BTS-6, and Avicenna's just going to get him up.
That's order he's spending. I don't. He lost his Chimera, and that was pretty likely to happen.
I don't think it's, right. But, like, I don't think it's that crazy to hit the smoke on that occasion. Because it's zero band. He's on 13.
4-13s versus 1-16? I'll take the 4-13s every time.
But well, like, what's the chance of winning that face to face versus the chance of him dying to the nanopulsar?
Right.
But an 8 to save?
Whoops.
Yeah.
8 plus 6, yep.
So, like, that means that he's 35% chance to fail?
Well, that was a bad move on my part.
Because it needs to be a 7? Yeah. And I don't think he wins 35% of the chance at the time, but, like, I think it's probably closer to 20. It's not crazy.
I don't think
a higher number matters a lot.
Nope.
Yeah, but then you have gotten rid of a guy as opposed to not.
Before I do that second move, will you put the silhouette for your...
I was trying to see the Prowler. Which I think the car perfectly blocks it.
I don't know if you'll be able to see him past that car.
It's hard to see. I think the car blocks it.
Yeah, car blocks it.
I can't get my camera down enough to actually see it. Just really.
You're not the first person.
How often does the 16 actually win?
How do I
options? Find
that out. I assume you just did the math just now.
I was trying to find my link for the Infinity Dice thing that I like, but I couldn't find it.
Hold on. Let's just find out.
Well, Lobo has some math. I assume he saw it.
No, drops down a menu.
Okay. But no. And then, like, if you hold right click, does it rotate the table and, like, move the mouse?
Oh, yeah.
So it's the exact same number? Is that what you're saying, Lobo?
Oh,
okay. It rotates around that.
Oh, I see what you're. Okay, no, I see what you're saying. Is you
so 30% of the time the eclipse goes down and you basically guarantee that you survive the rest of the turn.
Tim has ruled no.
I was able to get down at some point.
I'm right there. What happens? Is that...
The only thing is,
yeah.
I just don't see the red at all. Like I'm looking, I just don't see it at all.
Okay, so then I'll just keep moving.
So 30% chance for Eclipse to go down, or 35% chance to take out the bolt. I'd rather take out the bolt.
That's a good point. Yeah, that we'll see. Okay, so I'll wait. I'll spin the order and shoot the Morlock.
Okay.
That seems worthwhile. All right.
But, like, keeping the Uberfall there is a huge boon, right?
4 inches across that cap.
Because then it's a problem. You can't even, like, keep moving the bolt out. Because now you can have a chance to dodge in the melee and stuff, and you kind of wipe off that avenue.
Arrow.
65% of the time, it's just gone. I would not plan on it staying there. I don't know.
But, like, equally, I would not plan on you actually taking down the bolt.
I'm going to shoot you. It's outside.
The same chance. But I think that the bolt going down is less of an upside than the Uberfall staying up.
Okay, I disagree, but okay.
Okay. Well, only because Ivacena's right there.
Ooh,
11.
That's the only thing that gives me the big pause. Like, if you could take him down forever, I'm in. But because Ivacena's right there to just to fix the damage, and he can just move on with his day, I don't know. No, I do know. That's my opinion. That's where I think I am.
What was the range on that?
You know, Lobo, and that's the actual truth. And I think this is an important point for a lot of people to take away from this, is that a lot of times the question is not, what should I do now? And it's, what should I have done before this? Because, like, losing the Uberfall there was something that happened orders ago. It did not happen just now. The dice may have killed you now, but you died several orders back.
Okay. Sure. We'll yeah, I also would have tried to take out the Bolt and Avicenna with that one order he had.
Oh, there is a model there. Actually, I'm
gonna instead of Massacre?
I forgot about this. Get into base contact.
I mean, I'm just after Massacre, right? Because I think the whole Massacre thing was done. Not well.
Finish my second move.
But after Massacre, just walk over here and take out the two things that are threatening that piece. And then there's nothing else you're worried about, really.
I'm gonna change this guy back to not being camo because we're using it for...
Sorry.
It could be confusing versus a normal silhouette.
That's the only one he's got. He's only got that one.
Right, but I mean, like, let's not leave him in the silhouette if we're not using
it. Yeah, no,
not
bad.
Right, he used a bunch of orders on the Prowler, but...
We're going to go to...
And again, he went for the wrong objective with the Prowler.
Inches, get the bolt to there.
He went for the button instead of just going and kicking it immediately, which he would have saved a bunch of orders on.
We'll stay there.
And all they needed was one kick, and then he could actually spend the rest of the orders on the Chimera killing that Harris.
Can you Kindergarten? Oh my god, that was a 9 and then 10 to a 17. Can you Kindergarten when he's not unconscious?
Isn't he in a null state? Isn't that what I need?
Is disconnected or null?
I don't know. It's one of those things.
It's a fair question.
We're checking. One moment.
Cool.
Coup de grace.
My gut says no.
My gut says the opposite.
It's been wrong before. I have indigestion. I can't blame my gut.
Now, does it count? It says unconscious or...
So I'm either going to coup de grace or close combat it, I guess. Which close combat would be significantly disappointing. But it's there. So your dodge on your warlock?
The roll's in there. Cool. Oh. Coup de grace, if anything, it's in unconscious or...
Yeah, so it doesn't work on disconnected, I don't think.
Yeah. So you have to win first.
So it's a null state, but null is not what allows coup de grace.
It's got to be, it's gotta be unconscious on Emryo anyway.
Oh, Infinity. Yeah. Always the corner cases.
So I'll just do
and this is, I don't know, CB is even aware of this, I'd be surprised.
Yeah.
Not drawn line of sight on.
All right, there's a Morlock right there. That's
that could be wrong. He's running up to the standing. HVT.
Yeah, she's standing because the cards are enough.
What was his HVT? What was his classified again?
Coup de grace.
That's so he should nano pulse of them and then coup de grace them.
I'll just be prone. Whatever. We'll be
prone. I mean, you crit them.
That's very true. You'd have to be like that's that. Very true.
Okay. Just make sure they don't actually die. Because they have a sound that has a nano pulse or no?
No, I don't think either of them have templates.
Shame. Split burst pistol. There you go.
There you go.
It's pretty.
Instead of why won't you die, it's why won't you stay alive?
Why won't you live?
Oh, man.
It's called Why Rock Not Die. No!
Okay.
Is there smoke right there? Like what is?
Yep, the Morlock got shot at by the Spitfire.
Oh,
and threw smoke.
It's a shame he didn't throw it. Could he have caught the Prowler? That would have been pretty spice.
I mean, he could have, but you don't get to measure the template first.
Yeah. It would have been really spicy to just like plant it and save both models.
Sure.
I guess the angle like that plant really does protect the Prowler from the bolt angle pretty well.
That Prowler is weirdly safe. Like,
No.
You have to like walk up to his face to see him somehow. Like, I don't even.
Oh, the actual answer is that Zero killer hacker just like goes to the other side of the wall and blows his brains out.
Okay. I'll do that. I'll spend that order.
Then he can go kick the box.
Sure.
Pathfinder is going to move out, standing up, not prone anymore, to see the Morlock, and then move back.
At the risk of it being another advantaged mission, I'm so far very entertained by the challenges presented by Baypaw.
Sure.
I've enjoyed what we've witnessed so far.
All right, I missed.
I'm just gonna do it so that I don't block the if the Pupnik wants to run.
Wait, he missed? Oh, it's outside of 16. So Morlock threw more smoke versus the Pathfinder's shots.
Oh,
so
no, that's too far. You're right.
Because remember, if you're leaving this side, it won't block line of fire here.
Yeah, I'm going to put it like here. So that should block line of sight. I just don't want her to be in the smoke, and I want to not cover that thing fully, but that should do it.
Cool. Yep.
Yeah, alright, so just...
Why is it called B-Pong?
just means that Pupnik comes around the corner and gets one sniper shot at her.
I don't have an answer for you.
Like, the first thing I think of is beer pong.
Yeah.
Which makes no sense, right? Beacon pong? Because it's a tracking beacon?
Ooh, there we go. Beacon pong. There we go. That makes sense. And Lobo, I think that you have an opportunity to, as the first player, often you can rely on aggression to get what you want done. I think that because there is one objective that matters the most, that they can potentially shove the beacon several times into the enemy zone, into the side where your opponent does not deploy heavy.
Yep.
Like in this mission, if the focal player could push the beacon away from the nuns, I could see a world where it's very hard for him to both break through what you've deployed and to push the beacon back to your side.
Okay.
So all right, Crocman showed up. Was right behind this car right here.
Interesting. And he's going to the right. Strange.
He's got to be trying to do the objective, right?
Moira is about the only one.
That Crocman has to be a specialist, okay. Right?
I think it's Cube's forward observer.
Yeah.
I mean, the funny thing is, Crocman do all right at playing the bullet game.
Yeah, mimetism minus six helps a lot.
Well, also X-Visor. Like, they can take combi shots on nines from a very long distance.
Sure.
And like if you're fighting at 32 inches with the combi on nines, and you're giving neg 12 back to a ton of different guns, he's like, oh, I guess I'll die. 15.
Minus 9. 15. Outside of
24. That's true, Lobo. But then he still has to go to the other beacon, which would, in theory, be closer to where you've been fighting. Like, he can only do that once, right?
I mean,
because he can't push the beacon more than once. If you never touch that beacon, he can never push that button again. And then on the next turn, you can reshove it into his zone. I get what you're saying, that, like, they gave that catch-up mechanic, and it can be problematic in terms of keeping your advantage.
Well, it's also on your side of the board, so it's easier to kick it with your own guys. Like, this is a very hard game to win going first.
Keep thinking you're saying moderator. No, you're good. Okay. You have to come closer to like where the prowler is.
Yeah. Okay. So I can't make it. God damn it. Well.
Wait, hold on. Oh, no. Don't forget you've got O12 prestige.
That's fair. All right, I'll move to there. I'll go prone.
They need to call that something else. That does not tell you what it does at all.
Cool. So while prone, I'll go ahead and poke out to see the prowler.
Yeah.
And then move back.
Prowler's just going to dodge.
Boop. And then 1 point.
Okay, so this is a good shot. He's there. On what, 12s?
And it is a Crocman forward observer.
Very fair, Lobo.
Well, it's a moment in with the combi rifle. Yep, I'm just dodging.
Cool. So I'm shooting you on nines because you've got mimetism.
Mimetism minus 3, not minus 6.
Yeah, minus 3. They changed him.
12s. All right, cool.
He was never minus 6. He used to just not have hidden deployment.
No, he didn't. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. All right.
He used to be this kind of like weird light Dauphé.
Got.
All right, well, I got a 1.
Got him with a 1.
I'm going to say.
And he's fine.
That's impossible. Just fall into the... Go into the...
To go
smoke.
Just go in the smoke.
Now and touch time. The thing? No, I can't get that far, but still.
If you touch it, can it be booped? Like, it's not like a control thing.
Yeah, you just need to be touching it. It doesn't matter if anyone else is touching it.
Kusanagi, hey!
And a regular order.
It's everyone's favorite part of the stream.
Kusanagi.
Gonna
no, bye.
Stand
okay, bye.
Up, to see
she doesn't want anybody. She just wants toys.
All
right, off you go.
And then back, so it's about 3 inches. Then I'll get about to there.
And Bolt is doing something? DM?
I mean, I assume that he... Is he just, like, killing the Morlock?
I think...
Because Avicenna's there to get him up?
Three, isn't it?
Because he wants to get... If the Morlock's up, it might just kill both of them.
Sure.
It's just like, all right, I'll kill you myself. Template,
you? No.
He does not.
Wait, whose hand is weirdly light?
16's there with the pistol.
Oh, it's the light lighting up the hand. I think it's affected.
Oh.
I'm going to
I was like, what the?
If I, is my vision okay?
4 dice on 13s.
Okay, seven.
Window. Hey, that's a crit and a hit and a hit. Brat. So 4 armor rolls for you.
Everybody, I've been playing, building my Bushido guys up.
Zero.
This is my Tengu today.
I'll care whenever anyone up here plays that game.
I mean, that's very fair. I was talking to the internet.
Well, Growler now.
You got your crow person.
Haka! I have a whole bunch of crow people.
All right, Morlock went down.
Lobo, I will happily give you a demo at Armageddon. That weekend, I will happily make some time. We can play a game. Yeah, the models are incredible. They're so fun.
So he's... he can't push this button. He doesn't have anyone close enough to the dingle to hit it.
I think that he feels too threatened, like, he feels too threatened by what was nearby to do more of the mission stuff. Like, this is the Bakunin's game to lose, right?
All he has to do is move his Prowler forward an inch, and he'll get 3 points and win the game. He could spend one order on turn two and win.
You know what the worst thing is?
Hmm.
Man, I didn't see this angle, but where the nun sniper ended up, she sees an S2 walking through that, like, gap. Like, if
that
Avicenna...
gap.
sorry, I was about to describe it better. Where Senior Massacre was hiding previously, that the gap between the concrete and the red buildings, an S2 walking through there would be seen by the sniper.
11.
Sure.
And then the second one.
In fact, I think that this would be a great time for that sniper to move forward on that rail. He would see a lot of things.
Oh, cool. Unconscious. That's...
Who did he just lose?
We have an unconscious model. Okay. So this one back here.
I don't know.
Oh, this Pupnik back here.
right? He's still trying to just be like, I want to beat one of you to death. I don't care which.
I don't think he has the movement.
Avicenna would. She moved 6.
Huh?
Avicenna moved 6 too.
Oh, I didn't see it right there. But he wants to say touching the thing for the points.
The bolt can move 4 and get to the thing.
Fair enough. Yeah. Fire teams go. But then Avicenna's in the wind.
Well, the funny thing is, I think the sniper also sees... No, he would just see the other side of it. What a weird thing.
If I'm looking at the Farabot correctly, I think what I see is... I have a sliver of a line if I stand up to see the Morlock. And then if I continue that line, the Moira is enough to the left of it that the smoke blocks it. And then the Moira on the ground is... No, the Moira's farther. Moira's, this one's farther. Never mind, that one's farther than I thought it was. No good.
What a weird glitch.
Also, I think, looking at the silhouettes, Morlock...
lower your camera real quick, just angle it up.
Yeah.
So you see lower. Do you somehow see through that building?
Yeah.
Okay. It's weird.
It's a scanning issue.
Okay.
Oop. But the other side.
Wow. We're trying to see an aw pupper. No. We will be friends and you can't leave. Okay, bye. She's in toy mode. She just wants toys and nothing else.
That's fair.
She was at puppy daycare while I was at the tournament, so she just wants to play with her things at home, which I get. I get that mood. It's a big mood. Yeah, it seems like this is Bakunin's game to lose.
Literally, he just needs to spend one order next turn and he wins.
And which is that? Just to
touch the thing.
So touching the beacon itself gives you points?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He's got one for having this one. He's going to have one for it being on the right side. If he touches it, he's going to get the third.
I am baffled that prowler is a lot.
Okay. So I stand on this corner.
Right? Like, it seems like everything was working against him for that.
Active turn with a combi rifle. Oh, no, I can't even see you because the car is in the way. Yeah, if you spend three orders running a combi rifle up there,
but which faction have you seen that you like? What's been your favorite model that you've seen?
I'm so inclined.
Yeah.
Let's see.
I'm going to take the Bushido talk offline. It says nothing to do with what we're watching right now.
I accept. We're going to finish this turn. All right, message me. We'll talk.
It looks like his last order is...
I think the only thing you could do is try and dodge across that gap.
Is on the Chimera, it looks like, maybe?
I could actually move across the top to the other side.
Because he's on the top.
But I don't... That doesn't improve it.
Again, thematically fine, but I dislike...
It doesn't make anything better.
Yeah, you could, like, climb over the roof like a spider. Yeah. You could. But then the smoke disappears and the Moira's like, hello.
I'm just so ready to do the 5-man specialist soccer team. I just want to do it so bad.
Sure.
What specialists have smoke grenades?
Ermendinos.
I can link.
Do Varangians?
They don't, not specialists.
They don't have any specialist profiles?
Have ever seen it on that group?
He is in that group, but I pushed the button.
You want a 5-man link with smoke? That's asking for a lot.
I just want us. I mean, I guess I will accept having just 4 specialists. How about that? So that sounds like Caledonia has a great time.
You win the game no matter what, because I have to score all the points turn 3, and if I score 4 points turn 3, and you score... If you pass
your next turn...
his
dilemma.
Yeah.
Don't do anything. Or it's going to spend one order to move the Prowler up.
That's
you score
points.
3 points. And then if you do your classified, that's 4. So that puts you at 6. And I can only score 4 points in the last turn.
Yeah.
I mean, if Avicenna stays here, you'll get a point there also.
Right. So I'll get up to 5. Which, you know.
Sure.
A consolation prize.
That's all right. Moral victory. Find something you really hate and kill it.
Yeah. There we go. I think that's where I'm at. I think I got nothing else.
Wild. Think the thing you have to kill is the Prowler. Because how is that guy alive?
Right. I have to kill the Prowler and the Morlock. But I don't have the orders or line of sight to do it now. All right. Go ahead.
It turned into Bakunin who couldn't throw smoke and half. Securitates that couldn't shoot for some reason.
Oh yeah, there were a few of those where I rolled above my.
Well, you rolled one on him. He passed his armor safe and then jumped into the smoke. The HMG can see here, Carney.
Avicenna's actually kind of hard to get off that. He doesn't really have anything on that side of the board but the moderator.
Okay, first things first.
Maybe the Prowler with the boarding shotgun can just go kill her.
Still got the stamp up, still got the two more.
He can recamo and just, like, leave.
I don't have that anymore.
I mean, he could, but why would he?
So
you
I
can touch
a,
it. Does
one,
it have to
two,
be touched
three,
with a specialist?
Five, which is the
for the
extra
I doubt it.
So the Morlock can go do that.
Moderators,
and then the Prowler can go do the thing.
Yeah, two moderators.
Yeah, it does not have to be a specialist.
The Prowler moves up to here and then moves eight to go behind the car, recameras again, and then goes kills her.
Other team. Yeah, is this anything worth punching? Not really.
Actually, let me. Hold on one second.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no, because that would just risk dying. Never mind. Never mind. There's like an opening to spend an order on the Chimera to get a combi shot on the Morlock, but then you just.
Oh yeah, no, you could, but then I could.
Never mind.
So I think it's been the last two command tokens to get 9 orders in one pool. Yeah, sure. So I'm gonna put the Stemper in the main pool and this freaking. Moderator in the main pool.
Oh yeah, I guess he could have done that with the Stempler
too.
So
now it's always just a moderator and
just skitter on over here and shoot the bolt and Avicenna, and then group one do the things.
Do an impetuous.
All right, he's impetuousing with his 6-4 Morlock.
Like technically, it's the stupid thing. I shouldn't do it.
Yeah. Well, I mean that's why I'm chanting to do it.
Yeah.
I could always fail my dodge with the Chimera. That is perfectly possible.
But no, it's more that if I like I that's the annoying thing. Like the extra speed seems great, but it's actually really fucking annoying.
Yeah.
Because if I do it, I have to run like out here, and I'm gonna like hit the car.
makes it sound like he's just gonna
to death.
Impact
well, yeah,
the car.
But it's a 6-point model that if you take out the Chimera, significantly reduces my capacity in that corner.
The 6-point model that's doing a lot of work, so unfortunately it's just going to stay there.
Okay. Yeah, the Morlock has to stay there to touch the beacon to get that point.
Yep. Easy points.
Okay.
Yeah,
I'm sick and tired of this HMG.
Cool. Night, Grizzly!
Activating... yeah, I have to run across the entire, like, halfway across the board to do it, but I'm going to do it. Okay.
I don't think so. You just climb up the ladder. I mean, you lose cover, but you're at my long range with the sniper, so you're at, what, you'd be on 16s, and I'd be on minus 9, so I'd be on 6s.
I did not notice that ladder there. Yeah, getting the sniper up there to just wreck that HMG's day.
No, I just probably got enough distance to get up there.
And that's only because we allowed them.
It'd be an entire order. It would be.
Normally you couldn't
see
on that roof.
If you're on that,
I mean, it says no deployment. I don't know that it said no walking onto it.
It's probably worth the template up there just to make sure, because if you're poking up above that building.
I would have normally made that jump of logic.
No, I would be able to see.
Absolutely.
Not me.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, wait. Yeah.
Wolf, gotta stand up.
Oh. Desperate, am I?
Yeah.
So I'm just thinking of what I'm
doing. Those sounds were your back cracking. I understand.
Those sounds were just everything cracking. My liver. You know what, this thing's pointing down too much. Is that better? Is that good? Yeah, cool.
Is do thing.
You know what? No guts, no glory. Let's do it. Oh, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
At the very least, he could climb up there, right?
At a minimum.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 7, 8.
How many moderators are in the second pool?
There's two moderators in the second. Oh, so there's one moderator in the second pool now.
And then there's two in the first pool?
It should be 3 in the first pool now. Hold on, I can do this.
Got this. Yeah. You've got 10, because you got 5 for the fire team, 3 moderators, the Stempler, and the Prowler, right?
Yeah. Oh, right, because I didn't have the Prowler last time, because I didn't have him on. Because that is order from hidden. Okay, yeah, cool. So, yeah, let's just do it. All right, I'm going to spend my lieutenant order on the Moira.
Wait, he didn't even use his lieutenant order last turn.
Just because I know that this thing's a pain to try and put
Moiras have NCO, guys.
The ladder. So she's just going to be...
Yeah.
Yeah,
she's going to just be like...
It's real good.
...point in the ladder.
Yep.
He might have done it and I missed it. That's also a possibility.
HMG yet.
They're roughly exactly where they started, though, so...
HMG's just going to move out.
Oh, no, the sniper is slightly to the left.
Depending on how placement on those ladders works, I think there's a possibility I see you at the top of the ladder, maybe the last, like, two rungs, but that would be it.
It'll be fine. Like, you'll see me climbing up, and I won't get covered for the first shot.
Right.
Right, looks like he's going with the Moira sniping option. If he happens to lose,
I guess it's 4-4.
That'd be really funny.
That sniper is just gonna stay down the rest of the game.
And then
you don't want to bother getting Agatha up there. I guess if you were on the edge of the roof, you could medkit her
up. Straight up, right?
Probably to the.
Yeah, but that's.
I think it's only like
2-6-2. It's not bad.
I don't know. I wouldn't bother.
Yeah, it's 2.5.
Okay, cool. So 2.5. So 3.5. Cool. Yeah, I'm just climbing her down.
Yeah.
2.5, and then. And I get another inch here. Yeah, cool.
And yeah, getting a sniper up there is gonna be gross.
Can't be seen.
Okay.
Because the Chimera won't be able to go anywhere.
It's really not gonna matter.
I mean, okay. I just feel like
I won't
so
move
far,
her.
Like
she'll just.
Yeah,
she's gonna get on that ladder, just not seen, because the next move will be her.
She'll be right about the her toe will be on the third rung from the top.
Yeah, pretty much.
So, what's the long? What can we take from this game? Because like points wise, it's over, right?
I mean, it could be. It really depends on what he does.
Well, but like.
That's that order.
We already talked about that, like, there's no way he can catch up if he just touches it, right?
Yeah. Again, Link.
If he touches it and does his classified, correct.
Right, she'll end up on the roof. I'll just finish off doing the rest of
it. His classified? No, his classified was nano espionage.
I think if you stand there, because of the way
he needs to do enemy specialist with his Agatha.
By being there, I think you would have to actually move back to the side. You have the movement to do it, but just to...
Yeah, I mean, I got a sniper rifle. Why would I not want to be further away?
Or he could do it with a prowler.
Yeah,
you were saying
right,
to run at the Avicenna, cool. Right?
He'd have to take.
On a
10. Yeah, but again, he needs to touch the thing in the middle. That's worth 1 point and takes zero risk.
Crit you though, and she goes down. That's a huge order sink. So I'm gonna shoot you. We'll be outside of 32 for sure.
It's actually closer than I thought. It looks like it's 36.
I'm just moving everything else up while we do this.
So I'll be +3 for Link, -3 for range, and then -6 for momentum. So I'll be 2 dice on 6s.
Yep. And 3 dice on 15s.
You know, the best part about this is, even if I crit her and she goes down, I'm still out of the game. Well,
12's like 2 crits.
I know, right? Double crits. So that's 3 hits for you, right?
That's 2 hits. It's only
4
armor saves. It's only 2 hits, yeah. 4 armor saves. Because the 18's a miss.
Using a multi sniper, those are 2 DA damage 15s.
Pop, pop, yeah.
That guy is gone.
Oh,
Genzo.
Like a freight train.
Yes. Gone like a freight train.
Like yesterday.
There.
Like a soldier in the Civil War. Bang, bang.
Spend an order.
What are you talking about?
Going to camo
the it's a country song.
Okay. That's
fantastic.
Fair.
Gone like a freight train, gone like yesterday, gone like a soldier in the Civil War. Bang. It's not a good song, but it is a song.
It's a song that exists and happened to all of us.
Oh, his prowler's doing a thing.
Order there. I'll use stealth. I don't want anyone to dodge.
Yeah.
And he is risking points for some reason. See, this is what I'm talking about. He was not guaranteed to win.
It's not risking points given he's not looking for dodge, and the Morlock can just still walk over there.
I'm gonna have to. Yeah.
Then the Morlock's coming off of his point.
Yeah, no, I'm going to have to.
The Morlock gets a point for touching. Yes, it is. He was only guaranteed a tie.
Order there. Next order.
Okay.
Should be enough to get to see your Crocman out of cover.
Cool.
Yeah,
I will delay my ARO.
This is a...
I should say Crocman does not have a... Okay, yeah, cool.
He might be trying to get his classified? No, because he's not an engineer or doctor.
Just in case you're going to be real particular thing. Yeah. Yep, I will reveal to be the freaking Prowler.
You got CC 16. I've got CC 14. You probably got D charges though, right?
I do, actually.
Yeah. Okay, so you could just template me. So I guess I'll dodge.
Cool. I'm going to slug you.
Cool.
So two hit mode boarding shotgun shots.
Yeah,
on flats.
Because of your mimetism.
Cover, and then six.
No, does not have cover.
Hey,
he broke the corner.
Nine.
Oh, I missed that.
I got nothing. Well, I got a full.
All right. Cool.
So just engage.
One additional order before you eat your untimely demise.
No, he should have engaged.
If I go back there, let me.
Like
look at, if I put
it's a coin flip, and then.
Yeah, no, I won't.
Like,
if I'm
covering him with the Farabok at that point. No, I don't think I am. I think you can still shoot him without getting the Farabok.
Yeah, no, you'd have to be pretty much, like, over here.
Okay, so let's go.
Yeah. Yep. Now, Keith, the two hidden deployment models with terrible CC are now in base-to-base.
Who here was predicting that both of the hidden deployment models would be kissing?
I know, right?
well, not me.
No, espionage. It would be great, right? Or does it have to?
He
be
can't. It's got to be. It's got to be Agatha.
Ooh, as he died.
That's a shame. D charger.
Nope. She. That is a she. Take it back.
Do they both have D charges? No, just the Prowler.
Okay. Well.
I give them D charges.
All right, six
and Berserk.
And Berserk.
You could shoot into the close combat with your sniper.
I was actually thinking of doing it with the Stemper and using triangulated fire.
Oh, that's good. Job.
Oh!
Really better off.
Love that!
Can he see where he's at?
I think if I'm... You
know, yeah, he's got that.
I need to guarantee... as many points as possible.
Too late for that, sir.
No, he got points with me.
Holding
that counts.
Oh no. Engineer, doctor.
Is the Fearbox standing? It is not.
Oh, I actually need him dead. Damn. Okay, yeah. Anyway, order. Flip it. Let's go. I guess the Moira team's going to be moving out because that's what I got to do. Yep, Moira team moving out. What could be
better? I get, he's got plenty of orders to touch the thing
Moira's
with.
Moira's going
to
be back to where she was, so that third one from the top.
Somebody else.
This one here. Link team leader, probably say the sniper. Mother Agatha.
I'd leave the sniper up there. Like.
Not that really.
It's just like the four of them leave, and the one's just like, I'll watch the world.
That is a pretty solid... Yeah, it covers the entire right side of the board.
And left.
Nothing's going to happen on the left that it can see.
But it covers both.
It does, but that's less relevant.
2.3. You have to go back. There. Yep, that's all of them. And then she's probably going to go... Can you just do the measurement from that third rung and see if the sniper gets to the ground?
It does.
Yeah. Okay, cool. All right, yeah, she'll just pop on the ground there.
Yeah, yeah. That's
cool. Yep. And then Cenobite will move out two. Hold on. Bear will move out four, so the Cenobite can move out two. Wait, forwards.
Now,
guys, I don't think I'm going to be able to get this console.
Tells me. I believe.
I believe in the thing called Uber Volcomando.
God, I hate that new model so much.
It's not that bad.
It's order. Terrible. Furry, oversized abs are weird.
It's going to be.
They're weird, and I don't like it.
Agatha. Yeah, sorry, the link. Amazing is not for Agatha. You.
Sure.
Yeah.
You watched Westworld, right?
Awesome.
Long time ago.
She's gonna go.
Just the first season.
Did you ever hit this button?
No, I never hit it.
Green stuff solves all problems. But I have zero skill with that. I don't disagree.
Luckily, you're not trying to do something hard. Just fucking flatboard that.
Do I use a chainsaw? Is that how I do it?
Ideally, that's always the answer. Well, were you considering not using a chainsaw? Given the opportunity to use that chainsaw?
I've used a chainsaw once in my life.
How was it?
It was fucking amazing.
I know.
Up to here.
I said it more rhetorically. It had to be incredible.
I took down a tree. It was great. Hold it back because I don't want this link to break. Sorry, your audio cut out. What was that?
I went crazy. That's fine.
I could point out all of these guys still.
I said, I died. I destroyed nature.
Until you hit the button.
They all have stealth?
2 inches.
What?
Cenobites don't have stealth.
Oh, yeah, actually. I was just thinking that Cenobites might be the only ones that don't. Yeah.
Alright, well, I'll dodge if I get
clank, 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 go clank. I am sneaky.
Yeah. Alright, so he spent a few orders. He's moving into the midfield with his whole...
Is that your second short skill?
Five, man?
Yeah,
1, 2, 3, 4. Where's his fifth?
Because I can't remember. Alright, Chimera first.
Oh, it's dark. I see it.
That's a success. Up in a second. Also a success. So Chimera is just going to move down, but stay prone and stay out of line of sight.
Really milking that Eve for all it's worth.
So she'll just move down like half an inch so that she is about silhouette height above
her Winter Soldier
the
ground. Sure.
Still prone.
Yeah. Yeah, they're crazy.
So that if she falls unconscious on a wall, I can, in the unlikely event that I push through that fire team, bring her back up.
Yeah.
Huh. Cute.
If you don't, then the last few seconds of whatever movie this is will be her falling from the ceiling to the floor slowly.
Right.
Falling a whole 5 feet.
Still gonna be the link team leader.
When you're, if you're completely unconscious, that could fuck you up.
It's gonna screen forward 6 to here.
Your voice cut out again. I don't know what's up with your headset.
I guess Pupnik will move to the ground also.
But luckily, she has abs, so she'll be fine. Such a fall as that.
No, this is the normal looking one.
Abs under there, you're a fool.
No, she's actually just gonna stay. She's gonna go back here. Okay. That's Cenobite. No one else is gonna move. And then Agatha's gonna push that button. Whip 14.
Ship it a move.
Succeeding.
No button for you.
Yeah. Alright, let's do that again. Oh,
Jesus,
oh.
Roll the 17 and then a 19.
I can feel Frog coming back to me.
The best part about this is I still can't win the game.
I mean,
Morlock's going to cautious move. I can't because I'm not close enough. I'm too close to you, can I?
Yeah, I don't have anything that's looking down there. So you can just
if I move across here. when you see.
What's the, it's not
you're
that.
In
you
zone
cannot...
of control of the Chimera.
Yeah, nobody,
without stealth,
nobody
you can't
see.
Cautious.
Right, and no, she can't see there. I just moved her closer to the ground so that if she goes unconscious, she...
It doesn't matter that she can't see. He's in zone of control and can't declare a cautious
right,
move.
Right, right, right. But I'm saying he doesn't need a cautious move.
Oh, like, from her. Sure.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, well, then
different
I'll
issue entirely, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
My bad.
Sorry, guys.
All right. Is the Morlock going to touch the thing, or is he going to run into combat, is my question.
I'll dodge.
Is there combat to be had?
Yeah, the Prowler and the Crocman. Okay, he's just touching the thing.
Yes! No!
All right, well, I'm... Maybe I'll just
I have simple wants
this
in this life.
Be less stupid. Yeah.
Well, hello there, puppy. Are you saying
okay,
you would like
so
a toy
what
throne?
Do is we're going to...
I can help you. Would you like to form an alliance?
I'm going to put it on the fire team. I think there's going to be the link team leader again.
What is he doing with them now? Is he going to try and let press the button again?
I mean, might as well do it while, like, does he have two orders? Because I feel like you could
really
circle Agatha around while pushing the button, and then have her just go kill the Chimera.
Sure.
I like that plan. Because if the Chimera's gone, there's, like, nothing that'll dislodge those guys.
Sure. We're just going to have to do that. Okay. She's going to move back four. I've got the orders to do this. Sniper's going to move back four. Get to there.
So she's probably going to position the sniper up top.
Sure.
She'll stay where she is.
Yeah.
In all honesty, everyone's just going to stay where they are. Agatha's going to hit that button.
And then triangulate.
She's sure going to try.
Wait, before you hit the button, hitting the button doesn't get you a point. Controlling the button gets you a point. Hitting the button right now would move the tracking beacon away from the model who's controlling it.
Well, it has to be within two. I don't have to move.
Right, right, right.
Two.
Okay.
I suppose that's true. Why am I doing this? That's a good point.
I don't know is my answer.
You know what? Stuff all this. I'm going to use that order. Go back to where you were. I'm going to use that order on what I originally thought, which is I'm going to move... this dude to try and to stand. No, can I squeeze to see there? Yeah, I'll go to the edge just to see this combat on that Crocman.
Of note, you saw him where you started.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, your prone butt saw him. We were laughing about it.
Oh. I should have. Oh, I couldn't have shot anyway. Oh, okay, well, I'll spend the thing. I'll just triangular fire him.
Cool.
Oh, that's definitely not where you were. There you go.
Oh, am I? Oh, yeah, go put me where I was.
Yeah, your butt pokes out on the side here, and so it's just like exactly sees the Crocman.
So I guess I will.
So what's he shooting on? Eights?
Yeah, and I'll just take some bullets to the face, I guess.
Eights.
They all no.
One
okay.
Hit, two on. Okay, so I got two armor saves on my dude.
Are you still the hero we need?
Oh man.
I kill my own dude.
Nope. Oh, mine too.
They both die.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Kill everybody.
Well, the Prowler actually dies. Like he's like gonzo.
Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, the Prowler's gone.
Well. Oh. I mean, this is.
Let's
think about this game. Larger scale. What, other than the alpha strike we talked about initially, what do you think that Foco could have done differently to, like, not fall so far behind?
He needed to take out some of the long range pieces, and then he could have stood his long range pieces up. Like, his Fearbok hasn't taken a shot this whole game.
Is gonna be on the
yeah, I think
again.
That it was a short sighted deployment by him.
I'll make the Cinnabite the link team leader.
Where he, like, even if it stood up, what angles does that for about
HMG. It sees down this angle.
Yeah, it is so pretty much.
But
But like, even if he went all the way to the left,
and also sees the table that they were all on.
This is gonna go.
Table.
Sorry, this thing.
I guess, but.
And then.
It sees off to the.
He deployed that there after the nuns were there.
So she's gonna go.
So he knew
that
would be a terrible fight for him all the time.
And then.
Why wouldn't he instead place that where it's watching a different?
No. He went first and deployed first.
And this.
You are correct. I think about it. Okay. Sure. All right. So in that case, like, he was gonna use that as part of his defense, and he's like, "Oh well, those nuns are spooky. I want no part of that."
Yeah, and we're just gonna be facing forward, and hopefully. Oh, and sorry, and the one thing I'll do is Agatha and the.
Hi, Jagger. Hope to see you more.
Brian. Yeah. That's it.
Probably at our normal time though.
Yeah. Okay. So.
1, 2, 3 points. So that's 5.
It's not a good time to use an impression.
But he gets one point from touching this, so it's 5
it's
and 1
like
right now.
I'm gonna spend a bunch of orders
at the top of 3
on her dissecting your link team, because.
He did not do his classified yet.
Okay. So
if Kyle does his classified and pulls the miracle out of his butt and does all the other things, he could tie.
Of course, if I do an impetuous move and then crit the smoke.
Where's the ECT for security?
He's got it. He's right next to it. It's right next to the bolt.
All
right,
so I will. Let's look at my order pool.
All right.
She's in a relatively critless game.
Yeah, not many. I mean, we haven't been doing that much.
Not when you say that. Begin.
Right.
Oh, let me look at the other order pool now. So his Bolt Spitfire could pretty easily kill that Morlock and get behind most of his 5-man.
Oh, actually,
right?
Never mind. I'm just going to
just by going around this bus.
Yes,
the one doesn't matter. I can't see them anyway.
Cool. Okay. I think what I would like to do is leave my order pools where they're at.
Would the sniper see?
The sniper is way up there. Not until after he handled.
So I'm going to forego the impetuous.
The custodier and or Agatha.
On the chimeras.
So which angle are you talking about? From behind the bus?
Yeah, go behind the bus.
Actually, the
going
the standing
to
custodier,
stand up.
The top of
the
silhouette
right
would see an S2 walking, like, walking
so
through
I
here.
So I think what happens.
Okay, cautious
gives
move.
Me line of sight to the ground here.
I'm saying it would take more, probably an extra order.
Not to.
Got plenty of orders.
Well, they're both prime. So.
Yeah, right. So I think
they're prone.
I think I don't see anybody, but I can see the.
Sorry, I've got you turned down
a
lot. What were you saying?
Essentially, just walk.
They're prone. Does that change anything?
No.
Staying out of line of sight of everybody. This Pupnik is gonna walk. Not.
Or we're trying some real Uberfall shenanigans.
Also staying out of line of sight.
And I'm not convinced that.
Yeah.
That sniper can see that.
So we do have zone of control to. Her, but not her.
Like this HVT, it definitely can't see.
I would say probably the Cenobite has zone of control to the Pupnik where it starts.
It's just been dodging.
Cool. Okay.
Oh, no, you're right.
Definitely, yeah.
I'm going to throw some Eclipse.
Okay, barely it sees the HVT.
Oh, yeah, it was super tight. Like, I don't think they notice because they don't play TTS as much as we do.
Curious for both. Clint
What's
and
up?
Tim, and also for you, Jacob. My understanding of the way templates work with smoke is I put the template down and then, like, you know, get into position where it's line of sight. I don't pick a point
Choose
where
a spot,
I'd know where
man.
The template
you
is.
Pick
it's
a
harder.
Spot on the table, and
yeah,
that's where the center goes.
You have to eyeball it. It is a skill.
Okay.
Yeah, no, it's flipped and flopped between not even versions, just FAQs.
All right, so I'm going to go to...
I don't think that's accurate, but...
I'll go ahead and put it
I
right
can't
on
can't
seem
to follow FAQs like that. That's why I rely on you.
I've already found my dodges, but yeah.
Okay, so I'll do that. I'll try to put it there.
This is, I'm assuming, the irregular on the Chimera.
Cool. That's a good start. Okay.
Yeah, I guess you could just Chimera stuff, too.
All right.
Although, yeah, so, Agatha's forward.
You know, just because you got
Yeah,
Lobo, I do think you're correct.
Hopefully,
try to cut the legs from your opponent.
Okay.
Maybe shove it once and just make them interact on turn one if they want to come, and then put some friction up. But then, like, you're really just trying to make sure that they can't play the later game, so that you can secure it in their zone pretty deep.
Senna is gonna hop over this thing.
It's time.
5 inches to there.
He's gonna do his.
Don't think I draw a line of fire to anybody. Bolt's just gonna, you know, move back and.
I hate to say, I think Avicenna is seen by the sniper right now.
Whatever, All right, cool.
What?
Then I'm gonna go ahead and paramedic my Crocman.
I'd put money on it.
One or two? Is she best two?
I think she's just burst one.
He could have gone to the other side. It's not that big of a deal.
Oh
right?
No, that. That's
he can. Like that line goes right over the entire wall.
Oh no, I'm looking at the. I'm looking.
Oh
at
right, the.
I have on my army as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
All right,
they're
so
not going to see it.
Yep.
Seven is a hit, and the biz check for the Crocman motherfucker. Okay, cool.
I killed his Crocman.
He tried to bring up his Crocman?
Okay.
Yeah.
Wild.
Spend another order.
I guess he needed Avicenna to go back to the thing anyways. He could have gotten some free movement for the bolt here, but...
I don't know what his goal is.
Gonna move to about there.
He's just coup de grace and getting his classified.
Mm-hmm. And just to confirm, Cenobites don't have Panzerfaust?
Flash pulse.
Okay, that's fine with me.
It's a funny inclusion on them.
All right.
Weird. Yeah.
Another order.
In my mind, so you know that little like shape they have behind their head.
Because I would like to
it just
the
glows
halo?
Real
yeah.
bright. It just glows halo. Real bright and shoots a beam of light at your eyes.
That's like, the flash pulse. Oh man,
yeah, no,
that's great.
Yeah, she'll flash pulse.
It'd be actually really cool if you like, oh man, do an OSL on a Cenobite where lights.
Holy fuck, he's shooting.
31.
The Cenobite.
31. What's the range of flash pulse?
That's not great.
That's -3 on the flash pulse, I think.
Yeah.
But wouldn't that be really cool to like try to do like a OSL coming from the back of their head off their back?
Sure,
Be rad as shit.
I hit on a 2.
So armor save on me.
That Cenobite takes a wound.
Almost. Don't love it.
Cool. Right, take a wound.
Yep, and I will.
Alright, I'm gonna spend another order. Oh, yeah, go ahead and do your thing.
What was the range on that? Under 32, barely.
And this goes back to the sniper just saw that, you know what I mean?
Yeah, but I'm not surprised they're missing it.
It's a really tight line.
Like, he didn't move that far. He could have gone prone and done the exact same thing.
I think I would be annoyed if somebody tried to call that on me. Like, really? That line? All right, I guess.
And he's, he does not have the orders to do what I wanted him to do anymore.
Life's hard. Then you die. All right.
Like, he could have had 9 orders with converting the irregular and the new O12 extra order thing.
My mistake. I'm going to go ahead and move this up, Nick.
What you going to do?
3 and 6. And then the Chimera is going to go prone and just inch up to that corner so she can't quite be seen by anybody.
So pretty much you'd throw the smoke, if you're throwing smoke, where the Pupnik is right now.
Yeah. No, what I should have done is put the smoke in the smart spot and just put it right there, because then I wouldn't have fucked myself over. But instead I did.
I'm going to send the unload on that Pupnik.
Cool. I'm just going to keep moving.
Yep.
Chimera will stand up and move to
I mean, if Agatha saw the Pupnik, like,
I could have held. Okay, sniper.
Agatha's in smoke.
Well, I don't think, I mean, I guess you could have declared a shot against the other thing. But
just but well, if I held, you just would have moved the pumpkin. Nothing else.
Oh, sniper hits on the 17, right?
No, those are both misses.
Oh, cool.
He missed the Pupnik?
It's zero range band.
Oh.
On the Pupnik.
I feel like you're like Mushu from Milan.
You missed his right.
He was 3 feet in front of you and you missed him.
Shame on your cricket.
Either way, it's two dice, and either way, he's dead.
Oh, it's three dice, because... Wait, no, you're right, it's two dice. Yeah, you're right.
Okay.
Anymore.
I will... I'll spend an order on the Chimera.
Why was that two dice?
Move into close combat with Mother Agatha, but also being
doesn't matter. The objective. I think they might have forgotten total immunity again.
Mother Agatha is what is she? 22 versus your.
Oh, was he still? Yeah, he's still on a 5-man. Never mind.
So I'm gonna be hitting.
You just hit him twice.
Minus 6.
Yes.
I will have a plus 3 unless you have Natural Born Warrior.
No, 16.
She does.
She does?
Yeah, it's Nazareth Warrior, Martial Arts 2, and CC Attack minus 3. She's terrifying.
No, Mother Agatha. Mother Agatha.
Oh,
does.
No. I misunderstood.
Gotcha. Okay, cool.
Please continue.
All right. I'm just wondering, do I take a swing?
Yes, why do you not take a swing here?
Hold on. Either I take a swing or I just every other
one. You're on my channel. You always take a swing.
Yeah, well, I was about to say every other fucking thing is worse. So
every other thing is way worse.
Okay, and I
I'll close my eyes. What I'll do is because I may as well, if she dies, I'm going to also dodge with the
breaking the link team.
So that's a no.
Or
that's
breaking
a,
Agatha.
11's an 18.
Yeah. Correct. He
she
could still crit.
To roll a 19
because I'm assuming that's what you rolled.
Yeah.
To beat it, okay.
Oh, or roll an 18 to... Did not.
Alright, I beat you on a 18.
Yep, so two things on her BTS.
She's probably... Never mind. She's dead. Absolutely. I was going to say she's probably still alive.
Dodge on the...
What's the damage? What's the damage of a Chimera?
It's 14.
Fails.
Okay.
Dodge on the Cenobite.
Does that have extra damage anywhere?
Nah.
No, okay.
She's not cool like Andromeda.
No, and I don't think anything else is close enough to care. Oh, yeah. Dodge on the Moira. Which also fails. Is she
cool.
close enough to that? No. Okay, yep, that's it.
Okay. All right. I've got one order left. So, the bolt. Is...
Yeah, just the moment of hubris. Like, oh, no!
Guy, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do that. I'll move forward so I can at least cover things. So I'll flip this over, and then we'll go ahead and Bolt is going to stand up and move to...
Oh, he stood up. Maybe he noticed the...
Maybe he's from...
Yeah, that would...
No, that's no good.
Yeah, you'd have to either be out of cover or get to here.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to be out of cover. I guess I'll just move to there.
Yep.
Cenobite?
Yeah, Cenobite will...
Oh, he's just shooting the Cenobite again.
Dodge.
Yeah.
He's a hard man to kill.
Oh, this presents me with an opportunity.
Got him out of... Oh, no, he moved since
okay.
then, so
yeah,
he's in
I'll
cover now.
Got shot, went, fuck that!
Or fours, whatever they are.
Ben, okay.
Alright, well, I didn't crit, so...
Also, well, if I had been smart and used my bloody thing, I would have actually crit on that.
Before. Nice.
But, oh well. Oh, well, she just succeeds at dodging. Let's just not be seen anymore.
Okay. Alright, I think I have an opportunity here. Which I didn't think I was going to have, but let's go for it. I'll spend the command token.
So they're religious. Did you roll that?
No. I succeeded at the dodge.
My bad. Oh, no. I meant before.
Oh, yeah. Before you would have.
Yeah, sure.
Sorry. That's probably too late. My bad.
It doesn't really matter much.
Yeah.
Failed. All right. Okay, so I'm making another order appear in that pool with the command token, flipping it, and the bolt. Let me just make sure.
No! Leave it alone! No! Cool. It is facing the correct. It is facing the correct way, but
is it though?
It is. The red line is facing. The
is it?
Way. It's DTS. It's fine. He's in a corner.
No. I might be. Oh, I see. Okay. So yeah, you could have. Yeah. So she's facing that way. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I'm gonna move to there.
Morlock is going to drop smoke.
Cool. I'll shoot you. So hopefully we're within 24. Yeah. Cool.
Those are
so
pretty good numbers for the bolt here.
So am I. I rolled a 7. That's all right.
I got a 16 and a
1.
That's 16's a crit.
Yeah.
And the Morlock's down.
Okay. So now go ahead and spend.
So he's doing his darndest.
What do you think the possibility of this camo marker without
he's
any
trying real hard.
Skills moving through this area?
You'll have to go move and stop probably, and then do a full short move through there. That's fine.
Full short move? Oh yeah, short movement. Yeah, gotcha.
Right, short movement.
Yeah, because that would be one to get me there, because I can't stop there.
Yeah.
Okay. And then actually I could stop here.
You
though.
Could stop in there, yeah.
Yeah. So
if
we'll
you're gonna yeah. Spain.
So I'll move to there. Yeah. Now being up that high.
No one can see.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I think I'm clear. Cool. Alright, so I have a little more movement, so I'll get up to this corner.
Yeah.
Cool. I have to actually spend the order to do that.
Yeah, I was about to say. So he's gonna try and get his
Zero.
Down this way.
Zero over there. I still don't think that's going to be enough at this point.
3.5 inches to there.
There's no way?
Yep.
Arrows?
Nothing.
Cool.
I don't think there's anything they can see you unless you purposely put yourself in the way.
Yeah.
If he had one more order, he could have done it, but.
I'm going to go ahead and move. Definitely not going to have to do this. 4.
He's just now doing the math.
Oh, wait, no, because he doesn't have to stay.
Unless there's arrows.
Oh, no, it's an entire order, so he does have to stay touching it.
Nope, unless.
So he either kicks it over to the other side or he stays touching
so I
it.
I have to reveal myself
but not
either
both.
Way. It is 1 point for me and denies a point for you if I successfully move this back to your deployment or back to the other side. But you,
and I don't
yeah,
do it
yeah,
in
yeah.
my turn.
Right. Okay, so I will, because he's going to. You know, die. I will spend the last order there. Reveal that it's a.
Well, he
a
could
zero
still
hacker. Face him so he's not dumb.
What's the word?
And then attempt to
dodge
the command token thingy.
No, he already did that.
Okay.
Oh, you don't have to attempt.
No roll.
No oh, it's no roll. Do it. Oh, okay, cool.
You just move it. You just move it 4
kick
inches.
Kick the can, baby.
So I moved it 2, then you moved it 4, now I've moved it 4. And I have no more orders I can use.
So his last chance at tying at this point is dodging his 0 on the reactive to touch the thing.
I just have to survive with a 0 against your fucking fire team and dodge into close combat with that tracking beacon while also killing everyone approaching it. I got this.
Yeah, pretty much.
Step 3, profit.
Right.
Zero pulls down his mask, says, "This one's for Bran," and then gets shot.
Seems about right.
All right, so we're rocking over to the bottom of 3 here.
So at this point, I have 3 points on the table, correct? Because I've got 2 for this console for 2 turns, and then 1. Oh, no, because you took me off at the first turn. So I've only got 1 point for this console.
Currently, you only have 1. You have a chance to tie right now, is what you're playing for.
Yeah.
So he's just past turn. Better for him.
Extreme Prejudice no longer have the bonus point?
No, that was
it never did.
Oh, right.
So did you do that?
Yeah, remember I coup de grade.
Okay, it was just still in your hand. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I forgot to put it down.
Gotcha. So that's where your second point came from.
Cool. No more impetuous. I can't move anything, so I'm going to use this one regular order. Cool. On this moderator here. He is going to walk around here. And look at that bolt.
Cool.
Arrows.
To what end?
I guess I might have line of sight from back here, but I think you walk out of it.
Do bullets.
Oh, no, never mind. I guess it does have it. Yeah, I'll shoot you.
I do not have answers for you.
I'll shoot you as well. Chance.
16.
But yeah, you're right. If he does nothing right now, he wins.
And four. Okay, two hits.
This
moderator marksmanship.
Moderator knows how to shoot a gun? What?
Oh my god, he's a fucking thing.
I'm pretty sure that disqualifies you by having a moderator win a gunfight. I don't think that's allowed.
No, that's why he's lieutenant.
Yeah. Well, no, I actually like the Bunny Gale too much not to make it my lieutenant.
Shame.
Oh, so is this just... Did you spend this, or is it...
Did I not flip it?
The lieutenant order?
Oh, no, sorry, that's gotcha. That's
see,
that
I just assumed that was the order you spent.
Yeah.
No, he did the one in the second pool. Because yeah. It's just one moderator in that pool.
Bunny Girl's in charge, good to know.
There's okay. Two of them.
Wait. Now, what?
Never mind. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, I moved a moderator and a stemper with the.
Oh no! I'm talking about the because there's two of this moderator.
Yeah, sorry. No, it's absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay.
What killed the HMG?
What killed the HMG?
Who models to kill?
The it's sniper.
I missed that. Okay, I remember this now.
The Moira sniper on top of the roof.
Yeah, I guess. You have
with a candlestick. Wait, what?
Which way is she facing? Did I completely? Oh no! I did watch that. Okay. Yeah. She is supposed to be watching this corner.
All right, that camera is alive. I forgot.
Yeah.
Not as much.
So a Cenobite walks into the room.
If you want to spend the orders walking around the back, go for it.
I'm actually gonna.
So if this was a tournament, would you try and get more points out of this situation?
I really want that extra BS.
Yes. With how many orders I have?
Ooh, yeah.
Okay.
Eight
orders is so many.
At this point, doesn't lose anything, right?
But if you spend zero orders, you're guaranteed to win.
Is it
But
the only consideration I'd make is it super late in the tournament? And if so, how many other tables are at similar TP?
Hopefully this. Well, you can only dodge 3 inches.
I mean, with the current scoring, there's a giant cluster everywhere.
So I need deep OP then.
Okay.
That's the answer. Gotta happen.
Was she BTS 6?
No, 3.
3? Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Cenobite.
Cenobite,
okay.
Burst plus one, heavy pistol.
Just nanopulsar them both and hope to take them both out.
Run out in the open.
Or all three at this point. Jesus, what is he doing?
Actually, that's really dumb. I'm not going to do that. But only because you've got the
nanopulsar. Yeah, okay. He realized.
She's just going to move to here. In fact, no, she'll move.
This is the only specialist in the fire team, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. Let me know when you're done moving.
Yep. Yeah, and the Moira's. Moira's just going to move.
Yeah, I think that Custodier and the Stempler are all the specialists he has left.
Okay. So I guess I can throw smoke, but then you could just template me. So I'll probably just nano pulse your specialist.
Okay. I am going to. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna dodge with everybody. do the one that matters, which is specialist. Get away from it. 11. She does it. I think they're only
yeah, they're
fizz
11. She's
fizz
11.
Oh, that was a crit. I thought she was actually fizz 12. The Moira's a fizz 12.
It's near my normal bedtime for work, so it's like catching up with me.
Sure.
I'm old again, Gendos.
I just dodged with everyone else. Cool. Sniper.
I can feel it in my bones.
Yep, good. Cenobite.
Two little butters for over too much bread.
HMG succeeds. But no one actually wants to move. The sniper's okay. So you can just.
What is happening?
Cool. Yep. So on. Well, that may as well kind of in. So yep. It's a regular order. Another regular order.
Use this Templar. Shoot her with combi.
Link team leader is
yeah,
going
sure.
to be.
just deal with her from a range that she's bad at.
Which is like any range.
Any range.
Maybe I should have just. I couldn't.
In order to shoot her.
I could have dodged it like there, I guess. But now you would have still been able. Would have still been able to see her. Yeah, that's fine. I'm more concerned about just killing this one.
Yeah. Now.
Yeah. So. Yeah.
He should have been measuring zone of controls to see if his zero got dodges.
One out to there.
Yeah, technically true.
Towards you.
Like, I don't think he would have, but it's pretty close where this custodier was.
Yeah, maybe.
I'll stay away so that. Oh, actually, I'll stay away so you can't try and dodge and be in melee with.
Yeah, for sure. That's with an 8 where he started.
Everybody else? Actually, what am I doing? I'll stay over here. I gotta watch out for the Nanopulsar.
Yeah.
Everything else is just gonna move. Like, she's gonna stay in total cover from that, and she's just gonna move. Yes.
Of note, that sniper has to be way back to being total cover.
Those are like that.
Alright, it is really tempting to try to hit those two, but I think I gotta go for the Custodier. So I'll nanopulse the Custodier.
I will, in this case, there's no point in me rolling for it, so I'm just gonna 3-template you.
I don't think this hits the
what?
Moira behind her, but just in
case. Oh, well, I wanted to stay in total cover from you, so you shouldn't be able to hit her anyway.
Okay, yeah, so you should be further back for her then, because I think I do actually get a hit from there.
I think you see the side of you pretty deep.
Yeah, not yours.
Yeah.
Yep. Cool. All
right. Nanopulse.
Yep. And then you've got 3 bloody shotguns on you. Oh, I love
he
it.
He made us nanopulse save 20, and
20.
And the Chimera is gone.
Turned and failed. All right. She's dead.
Now apply a Cenobite.
Okay. Yep. So I'm
to
just
what?
Gonna do a return
oh, just
order
the thing.
On this right now.
Let's go kill the zero. And grab the, and kick the box.
I want to move everyone.
I guess you can just take the. Who currently controls that? Did anyone push the other console?
Pushing the consoles just, don't matter for points.
Not be seen by the.
No, but like, could he just push the console, which shoves it?
Yeah.
That's that. Okay.
But that would be 2 inches, and that would be back on the center line.
There.
So no one would get that point. Also, it would be right on the zero, almost.
He's gonna move 4 again.
That's funny.
No, I because I measured you revealed. I made sure to keep him out.
Oh, maybe they weren't today.
I don't know what I was trying to do there. Water there.
It's been a long day of Infinity for
Jack. They will all dodge. What's
more Infinity, more now.
Love the game.
I think you're too far away, but
we're,
I would love
we're
to
at
dodge.
Game number 4.
So
3 of
dodge.
Which I played. It's like a.
Loves it. Who's next in line? Hacker? Yep, Hacker dodge.
I just go lay down on the couch and just be a vegetable.
HMG dodge. No, sniper dodge. Okay. So
oh, these squares are bigger than an inch. I thought they were an inch big.
So,
Dodge.
I should know because there's circles on them that are an inch big.
2 inches.
Yeah, here's the centibite. He's like, hello. And he's like, how are you doing?
If I put the Custodian there...
I mean, he wants to dodge here. He's out of 8, right?
I don't think so.
Or is he now?
And the sniper succeeded. So, yeah, 2 inches again. I don't know what I'm doing with the sniper. I'm just like yeeting her and then. Like, and she can't go that far.
Do a thing. It's the, bottom, it's the end of the game.
Regular order.
Everything's dead. Right?
A lot of things are dead.
Remember that the Cenobite is wounded. Using that, dragging that with her.
He's got a thousand. Yeah, just shove.
He's just outside of 8.
We see each other right now.
Correct. I was wondering if his heavy pistol was in good range.
Excuse me again.
How many orders do you have left? 5?
5.
Because the Zero should be dodging right now.
And murder the hacker, and then spend one order to try to hit the button and run her towards the tracking beacon in case you don't hit the button. Yeah.
Cenobite's just going to go 6. Okay, maybe not that far.
I mean, it's like, it
Tim, move your hand.
You're within 8 inches.
Your green hand.
Oh.
Cool.
It was just right where he was trying to move.
Yeah. I'm here to be a troll in all things.
I will do 3 heavy pistols. 4 heavy pistols.
Yeah.
First 4 pistol.
Also, 12.
That's pretty good. I never noticed they burst 3 close range. That's real good.
Yeah. 3 9
fails.
3 hits.
Yep. And this will be game. Yep.
What was the 14? Combi?
It's dead 0.
Or dodge?
Don't think I can get the tie.
Probably a dodge.
Okay. Because combi would have crit. No, ODD. Never mind.
I don't even need to press this button, do I?
Just need to touch it.
Well, you need to move it to get the extra point.
Pushing the button only moves it 2 inches, so he's got to.
Yeah. So what you do?
Go kick your can.
You leave the Reverend Moira there, and then you just spend 2 orders to move there, and then get in contact, move the button, spend your last order to move into base contact with it. Right.
Then,
like,
and then 4, touch, do nothing.
So it's a whole order to kick.
Kick it.
Yep.
Interesting.
And then last order to.
To control it just like that.
Whew.
That's it. And then that's I also, because I'm close enough, I'd get secure HVT.
Yeah, killed all my shit.
You actually don't, because Avicenna secures yours.
That's why I killed the that's why I killed the bolt. I forgot
Avicenna. All people count.
No, that's fine. That's fine. I completely forgot she was there. Nah, you're right. I don't get that one.
Cool.
Well, there we go.
All right.
Right? I think that settles it. That Lost Lieutenant is the better podcast. So congratulations.
Yes, I did my people
proud.
I mean, at least until the next round, because we'll do another one at some point.
Yeah, the rest of the podcast, Josh and Nick are actually keen to jump on, do some TTT throwdown. So, if Lobo wants to come and show us how it's really done, or anybody,
Lobo's always ready to dropkick people.
Yeah, we definitely have a couple other people who are interested. So I'll coordinate with you guys and. We'll get another one lined up. Thanks, Clint and Tim, for shifting times and hosting us. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, thanks for that.
For sure.
Some interesting kind of moments of like important decisions made. Like, I remember very early in the game, the first thing we thought would happen was that we thought these guys were just gonna just come kill this whole team.
I absolutely thought that was gonna happen as well.
I just see it in my mind's eye. They're dead. Yeah.
My reality of spending orders moving a thing like that up is I get maybe 1 kill, and then, you know, through dodges and moving out of smoke, like, it falters, and then I've got a dude there who you just need to do 1 wound to, right?
Admittedly, up here, like, the Cenobite was standing up to look down and actually try and defend, and Mother Webera
confidence certainly plays a lot into it. Like, if you're not comfortable with it, then, like, play the way you want. I just remember the first when you rewatch this, the first half will be us like, he's gonna kill them all.
Right. I mean, my thought was I could spend the orders and do these two on the ground and then still have it back here and be relatively insulated. But then I don't have orders to do any of the objectives, which, you know, it's going first on this mission. So, yeah, you know.
Yeah, and considering the way, like, well, I mean, this is a new mission, and considering the way that, like, you can get to a point where even if you have a great second turn, you know, as you can see, like, you just can't recover.
Yeah. I mean, I do think there's something to be said for trying to do as much damage to this team as possible, letting you score as many points as you want the first turn, and then hopefully I've done enough damage that I can push back and deny you access for 2 and 3.
Yeah, but, and ultimately, I probably should have been braver with the sniper.
Yeah, there's, I mean, I had, you know, nothing I had was going to take it down except for the Chimera.
Yeah. And if I'd done that...
I'm going to do a quick little sum up so people can run away if they want. We got 8-3 victory for Loss of Lieutenants Jacob, right? It was Jacob?
Yep.
Yes.
And Bakunin. The battle is over, but it sounds like the war has only just begun.
Heck yeah.
Thanks you guys for playing. And thanks everyone for watching.
Yeah.
Bye, friends.
Cool. I mean, obviously, this is, you know, high stakes, and we're all super worried about it.